Or the group has accepted aid from other groups, even those the U.S. is not on good terms with. Among the first nations to provide the Peshmerga with arms was Iran. Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co. UPI reports the U.S. Department of Defense said it is considering three Colorado prisons as potential sites to house terrorism suspects detained at the military prison in Guantanamo Bay, Cuba. The Pentagon plans to send a team to locations in Colorado, including the so-called Supermax or ADX Florence prison, home to some of the country's most notorious criminals, including Unabomber Ted Kaczynski and Oklahoma City bomber Terry Nichols. Military officials announced they plan a visit to the medium-sized federal prison near ADX Florence and a state-run maximum security prison about 10 miles away, the Colorado State Penitentiary. The trip is intended to determine if any of the facilities will be suitable to transfer some of the Guantanamo detainees, but it will also help officials understand the potential cost of moving the detainees to similar facilities across the United States. The idea has prompted immediate pushback from Colorado lawmakers who say federal statutes bar them from bringing detainees onto U.S. soil.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports search and rescue teams on Sunday located debris appearing to belong to the cargo ship El Faro, which went missing in the eye of the Hurricane Joaquin with 33 mostly American crew members aboard more than 3 days ago, according to the U.S. Coast Guard and the ship's owner. Tim Nolan, president of the ship's owner, Tote Maritime Puerto Rico, said in a statement there was no sighting of El Faro or any of its lifeboats. With no word on the fate of the crew, relatives gathered at a Seafarers Union Hall in Jacksonville, Florida, where they were briefed by the Coast Guard and the ship's owner. Late Sunday, the Coast Guard tweeted that the debris field covered 225 miles and included styrofoam, wood, cargo, and other items. The Coast Guard could not confirm that the objects belonged to the ship, which sent a distress signal on Thursday morning in the Bahamas, but has not been heard from since. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Hello, this is anchor Doyle Redland. I have just been informed that my 40-year contract with the Onion Radio News expired 2 minutes ago. A brief extension has been added to my contract to allow me to say goodbye to you, my faceless listeners. I've been reading the news out loud on the air for a very long time now, and the words to describe my feelings are difficult to find. Steve, what are you doing? This is my big moment.
I'm getting the word now that you have to leave the studio right now.
But where will I go?
Now.
Well, goodbye, everyone. I'm just coming back for my hat. No, it's my hat. I just need it and I'll go. There's no need to get pushy. Moose! Rocco, I thought we were friends.
Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. We'll give you the toll-free number in moments, and also our Skype username that you can connect to us on. You'll have that here in moments. It's Ian and Mark in the studio as normal on a Monday night. We do have a special guest host with us here. Brian Henchy is in the studio. Hey, Brian.
Hey, Ian. Thanks for having me.
Sure. It's a pleasure. Our listeners who attended Keenvention last year will remember you as the smiling face who was working the attendance booth, if you will, or the ticketing area, if you want to call it that. We don't really hand out tickets at Keenvention. You just kind of put your name on a list, and then we give you a name tag when you show up. And you're going to be there again this year.
Yeah. And I was the strongman security at the front because they're the crowd's trying to get in. It was insane. I had to use all my strength in my whole body. We were able to safely keep Keenvention going.
It's a great little thing. We can talk more about the event here in a little bit. New panels been announced over the last couple of days at keenvention.info for you to check out. You've got some experience doing radio in the Boston area, and you actually drove out here from across, more closer, I guess, to the Manchester region in New Hampshire.
Yeah, just near Nashua. So I've done some fill-in in Boston. Is it okay to mention the calls? Or?
Sure, WRKO.
Yeah, 680 WRKO, and then also the on Cape station. Cod, WXTK in Hyannis.
I think RKO is like the only talk station that stays alive in Boston. All the rest of them just die off.
What does that mean, dies off?
They come and they go. You know how the stations, they flip formats, they don't stay with talk or whatever.
So we had Rush Radio, which turned into Talk 1200. Then we also had another station, which was a liberal talk station, WWZN The Zone. And then that has since flipped over to WMEX. And then they had a morning show. It was there for, I want to say, 5 weeks. And then poof, gone. And then they put their midday show. It's like a revolving door over
there. It's
bizarre.
Can you imagine that you've designed your life around working at this new morning show? Maybe you've picked up and moved, or maybe you've foregone some other career, or whatever your decision is that you made in order, because every decision requires deciding not to do some other things.
Sure.
You decided, I'm going to take this gig as a morning show host, plus realigning your life to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning to do a morning show.
It's awful.
And all these things, and somebody decides, you know what? That decision we made 5 weeks ago, we're just not going to stick with this. They didn't have any idea what sales or ratings or any of these things were going to be like at this point, because nothing's had a chance to sort of stick. This is it's basically evil to do to somebody.
So, Boston Radio, there you go. Toll-free number tonight if you want to join us, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I wanted to start the show out tonight with a story from Free Range Kids. And for those that don't know, Free Range Kids, we had Lenora Scanese on with us from the Porcupine Freedom Festival this
year. She's fantastic.
Did you get to meet her when you were there?
I've heard her in several different radio shows. I haven't personally met her, but I love how she is pushing for her ideas. She is totally anti-hover. What are they called? Hover parents? Helicopter
parenting. And now this is about the helicopter society. Apparently she's, what is she, got her own show now, World's Worst Mom on Discovery Life. So good for her. She does really great work. And she made the news years ago as the world's worst mom.
No, first she started out as America's worst mom, and then she got a promotion.
Oh, to the world's worst.
Yeah.
Okay. Because she let her son go home from school by himself on the New York subway system.
Yes,
and
that's the reason.
For whatever reason, made her such a terrible parent.
I can totally understand where people who are shocked by this are coming from. I get the feelings that they have.
You mean because they've been sold all this fear-mongering stuff about there's a, some sort of pervert around every corner and behind every bush?
I don't think it's just that. I think that you are what you find is that when you have a kid, this is the thing isn't the right term to use here, but let's just go ahead and use it just for the sake of comparison. Once you have a child, you find out that that is the most important thing in your life. Suddenly, you know fear. I will go ahead and say, you people without kids, you don't know what fear is like, because you're not constantly worried about what might happen.
Well, and then it's
amplified. What if they get out the door and then go out into the street and get hit by a car? What am I going to feel like? What are people going to think about me if I am lying there, holding my dead kid in my arms on the side of the street? These are the kind of things you think about as a parent.
But it's amplified by this sort of culture of fear, right? So you sort of have that natural tendency to want to protect your kids.
Yep.
And then on top of that, you've got people in the media, you've got other parents who are freaked out about all the dangers.
Well, there's some economics. There's some economics to it, too. When you think about children, for most of human history, were an asset, especially during the sort of agrarian times.
Working a farm.
You could put a kid to work at something like 4 or 5 years old, and by the time they're 14 or 15, they're basically an adult, and they're doing adult work, and they're getting paid zero. You know, so this is, they're valuable. They're an asset.
It's like the Church of Scientology. Put the kids to work. But
the whereas when it comes to when you're looking at kids today, you're dumping a lot of money into this kid. From an investment standpoint, you're dumping a lot of money into them, and there's really no output. It's kind of like a luxury car. Essentially, you get it because, well, you know, this is the next thing you do after you get a regular car, and you've got more money. So,
for all those parents who ride their kids to work,
I think there's an economics, things that go on in people's heads, sort of behind the scenes, and they don't really even know it. So, yeah. Anyway. Your kids are valuable to you, and that's why you freak out when other people talk about how they let their kids take risks.
Sure, but should you freak out beyond the point of high school, you know, when they're off in college? Because that's
when do you turn it off? How do you turn it off, Ian?
I don't know. I'm not a parent.
I know.
And I'm not interested in being one. Anyway, free-range kids. Apparently, some parents are able to turn it off, Mark, and Lenore Skenazy is one of them.
I would say most of them at some point or another are able to come to the conclusion that, hey, I've done the very best I can do up to this point, and now he or she has to make the mistakes they're going to make.
You know, if I had to guess as to how you turn that off, I would say it would be an ongoing process throughout the child's lifetime where the parent, when they think of the fear-mongering thoughts, the scary thoughts about what could happen, they just simply remind themselves to not think that way and to allow their kids to explore their world in as safe a manner as possible, but also with permission. I mean, going out there, letting them go to some extent and be alone and, you know, take their own route home from school and exploring the world. You just have to allow it.
I'm not saying you don't have to do it. Yeah. I'm saying
you don't have to. Some people are helicopter parents and they hover over their kids all the way through college.
Right. Well, this is the problem is that there's no guidelines, there's no rules set up there. So people are going to do a variety of different things. And I would say that the mini free rangers out there are even farther beyond what I'm able to handle, and plenty of these helicopter parents I think are ruining their kids' lives. So, you know, whatever. This is the great thing about being a parent is everybody else is wrong.
Well,
they're friggin' wrong.
Just to state the obvious, we have the media 24/7. Oh, let your kid walk out the front door. Boom, they're going to get abducted.
Right, you know, it's part of the
God
culture.
God forbid your kid does anything, right? Their bicycle two houses down. Oh my God, they're all of a sudden hit by a car. So we have a media that's constantly just pushing on to people that if you let your kids do anything outside of your visual reach, you are neglecting your kids and something bad is going to happen to your kids.
Sometimes that's what it's like.
Sometimes what happens that is bad is the police come and arrest you. You know, leave your kid in the car or something like that for a few minutes, and then all of a sudden it's a criminal act.
I have a friend in radio in Kansas City. He got in trouble because at a playground, not with the police or anything, but he went to go refill a water bottle, I think, at a water fountain that was like 10 or 20 feet away from his car. This other parent screamed at him because he was not watching his kid for like 30 seconds and had left his
kid
alone.
On a playground?
In the car, at a playground.
Okay.
And he
just
walked
go get some water.
Yeah, to refill the water, and
crazy.
It's ridiculous.
It's crazy.
We had, you know, to one-up your story, that we had a lady call in who was returning the shopping cart to the buggy corral thing.
How dare she?
Right? I mean, I don't know what she was supposed to do otherwise.
With her kid in the car.
Right. Well, what are you supposed to do otherwise?
You're supposed to push it to the end so you knock out other people's headlights.
I don't know.
Don't put it in the thing.
It's just nuts. Well, she was just taking it to the buggy corral. She
crazy.
Comes back. There's a breathless
How
woman
dare
standing
she.
By her car.
She hates children.
All right. If you've got a story about these overprotective parents, want to hear from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Or maybe you are an overprotective parent. You can call in, too. 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Skype username here is lrn.fm, and this is Free Talk Live.
Olive is a yellow lab, 6 years old, full of energy. But, oh, man, Olive was suffering, to use a word, like a dog. She was itching, she was scratching, she was licking 24 hours a day. She was shedding all the time, and it drove my wife crazy because she had to vacuum the house a couple times a day. So I'm going up the expressway, and the radio commercial comes on.
PD stopped eating. All of his hair fell out. Mounds and mounds of fur. Our hairballs have hairballs.
And I almost drove off the road because I thought this person on the radio commercial was living with my dog, Olive. And I called my wife. I said, dear, you got to check check out this product called Dynavite. Go to DINOVITE.com. So we started Olive on the Dynavite. In about 6 weeks, she almost has entirely stopped itching, scratching, stopped licking herself. Most of the hair has grown back under her belly. Unexpectedly, her coat has become smooth and shiny, almost like it was when she was a newborn pup. Olive is happy, and my wife is probably the happiest person because the house is cleaner. 859-428-1000. DINOVITE.com.
DINOVITE.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A-plus by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and of course you can join us here toll-free. Maybe you've got a story about an overprotective parent and how that worked out for them. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. The Skype username here is lrn.fm. Just send a contact request over first if you're not yet on our Skype list. We'll approve you, and then you'll be good to go to call the show from that point forward. And if you're on Skype, it generally sounds a lot better than does the phone, so try to make the effort to call us on Skype. It's worth it. You can join us here to talk about overprotective parents. That's what I wanted to discuss here, and I was inspired by an article at Free Range Kids, which is a great blog, freerangekids.com. Lenore Scanese, who we've actually had the pleasure of having on the show, she was at the Porcupine Freedom Festival this year. I'll tell you what she has to say about these college students. These are the kids who have been overprotected, had all the corners rounded off, parents freaked out at every little thing as they were growing up. Now they're going into college.
So what does that...
Well, come on, this didn't happen more than 20 years ago?
It certainly did, but, you know, we've got the... This is the article we're reading today. We've talked about this over the last decade, Mark.
I do think that things have changed over time, that it's become worse and worse over
time.
It
absolutely has.
But surely this was going on when I was in high school. I just don't know that much about it, because, well, I was self-centered and paid no attention to those other people.
So we'll get into that, but if you care about your privacy when you're online, you need ProXPN. It's a virtual private network. They encrypt your online data, which means your own internet service provider won't know what you're doing once you start using ProXPN. And that means they can't mine your data. They can't sell that data to other companies. They can't turn it over to the government. So it's really great for privacy. And they do it right, offering OpenVPN, which is the gold standard of network encryption. So go to proxpn.com/amp. That's where you get a special offer. If you pay with Bitcoin, you'll get ProXPN, 2 years of it, for a total of less than $50 worth of Bitcoin. But you can only get that price with Bitcoin, and $5 of your purchase will go to the Free Talk Live AMP program, which helps us spread the ideas of liberty. It's huge savings, the biggest we've ever offered on ProXPN
here
on Free Talk Live. It's only good for Bitcoin buyers. ProXPN.com/AMP. So that's a good reason to get Bitcoin, but let's just say you're not ready for that yet, and you've only got the Federal Reserve notes to spend. You want to use your credit card? You can still get a pretty good discount with code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live. And 50, as in you get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy the annual account with code FTL50 at proxpn.com/amp and or proxpn.com. Code FTL50. So with you in the studio tonight, I'm Ian.
I'm Brian Henschy.
And it's Mark.
Here's a story from freerangekids.com. She writes, Lenore Skenazy says, "My friend, colleague, and hero, Peter Gray, a psychology professor and the author of Free to Learn, one of my favorite books, makes the compelling case that we often make here. Kids need a chance to play, explore, have fun, mess up, get mad, recover, and simply live some part of their childhood unsupervised.
So irresponsible.
For them to develop the emotional resilience they will need. You can't become an adult if you get zero practice being one, thanks to constant oversight and intervention by real adults."
So
it's a real in quotes.
Yeah, this is it's an interesting question, right? Like, can a child learn these coping mechanisms when they become an adult? Because learning, your mind is different when
it's
you're a child.
It's easier to learn as a child, right?
Well, that's one of the things that are claimed, but certainly people will claim that that there's, you know, different stages of mental development on up to 25. These are one of the things that when some people say that young people aren't able to make certain decisions and that sort of thing, that I often bring up is, hey, whoa, your mind's still changing on up to the age of 25. Do you want to limit young people from having sex until 25? Do you want to prevent them from having to drinking until 25? When exactly do I become adult enough? Because I'd love to keep anybody below 25 off the road. Fine by me. Let's just limit them. I'm past 25. What do I care? So sure. But you know, people are always trotting out these different ideas.
Toll free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
I like how Mark just like goes and goes and goes, and then it's like you don't know when it's going to end, and you're
it's
like,
true, yeah. Get ready, be on your feet.
Should I?
This is why we, like Ian and I, get told constantly, we think you guys have synergy, chemistry. That's what we're told as talk show hosts, is because we seem to know when the other one's going to finish their sentences. I don't know. Maybe it's just we're used to their breathing and know what's going to happen when it ends.
You guys have done the show how long together now?
12 years.
Yeah, that's right.
So it's granted, it's bound to happen eventually. So right. I was going to say earlier about you said the child's brain keeps on developing till age 25. I think mine stopped at about 14. I'm just guessing there. But
why do you say that?
I think it goes further
than
that.
Are you saying you act like a teenager or what? What makes you say that?
I don't know. I feel like I haven't gotten a hell of a lot smarter.
Really?
Last whatever. But
I feel like,
don't take me too seriously.
I didn't. He's bad with jokes. I didn't really figure out adulthood until 30, maybe even past it. Why bother? I was paying my bills and living on my own and doing fine, but I just didn't really figure it out till then.
What made you feel like you figured it out then?
Responsibility.
But you said you were paying your bills prior to that. So.
Yeah, it's not the same sort of responsibility, though. I was like, sliding into third base is different than making it there and standing on third base. It's completely different.
So here's a story here. She's actually sharing a piece from Psychology Today, and Peter Gray is the author. She says she edited out just a little bit and added some bold face to it. Declining student resilience, a serious problem for colleges. A year ago, I received an invitation from the head of counseling services to join other faculty and administrators at the university I'm associated with for discussions about how to deal with the decline in resilience among students. That's an interesting term. At the first meeting, we learned that emergency calls to counseling had more than doubled over the past 5 years.
Emergency calls to counseling. All right. I've never, like, I've seen all these numbers trotted out most of my life. You've got this problem, that problem, or the other problem. Call this number. I've never considered calling one of those numbers. Yeah. You know, it's like, those people on the other end of that have lots more problems than I do.
You've never called 911 for any reason?
I've called 911 if, like,
411.
411 if, like, I need a telephone number or something like that.
611.
911 if, like, I've been driving down the road and seen, you know, an accident or a lights, traffic lights flashing or something like that uh-huh. needs to be fixed. I've called for that reason.
You've never called a suicide hotline ever?
Never.
No
drug treatment hotline.
Yeah, I'm the same way. I've never called a counseling hotline for anything. I mean, if there's something I needed advice on, I would ask people that I know. But I guess, you know, if you're all alone, maybe in a new place or something like that.
I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I've never done it.
Yeah,
it's funny. I didn't mean to bring that up, but in college, I had to take personality tests, and one of the jobs that least you give a list of jobs that match with your personality, and another list of jobs that did not fit your okay. personality. And one of the least matches for me was a suicide counselor.
So is this for college students that don't know what they want to do in life?
Yeah,
like, here, just take this test.
And
we'll
actually,
tell you.
Actually, it was through the counseling center that you could take all these personality tests and it would help to help you to figure out what would be a good profession for you to go.
I wondered why they had that on the list because nobody thinks of this as the, you know, like this is a career they want to get into. They may or may not be, you know, it may or, so, may or may not be good for them.
Do you feel
them.
Like
Let
you
me give
want to die?
A little bit about this, what this guy's going to be talking about. Like, an example of what resilience we're talking about here. Students are increasingly seeking help for and apparently having emotional crises over problems of everyday life. Recent examples include a student who felt traumatized because her roommate had called her a bitch. And two students had sought counseling because they had seen a mouse in their off-campus apartment.
God. I want to know who's going to do my laundry. These are the questions I have.
Toll-free numbers 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
In a move that puzzled patrons of the global fast food chain, McDonald's launched an extensive ad campaign this week entitled, "And Yet Is Not Beef Itself an Expression of Wanton Lust?" to air at prime time on several networks. The lengthy advertisement, which makes scant reference to any products or promotions, posits to viewers that perhaps beef is merely a symbolic expression of lust in its most wanton and depraved form.
When we call for beef, what are we really asking for? Is it the caress of a gentle lover? Or the blade of an executioner? The rage of steel on bone. Would you yourself deny beef? Would beef deny itself of you?
In other news, a spaced-out flower child is grooving on a doobie wave. A new study reveals nothing Pfizer's lawyers can't take care of, and the parents of an adorable child on a TV show are most likely insane. Thus ends nature's majestic cycle of weekly news reviews, only to gracefully begin itself anew in exactly 1 week's time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it.
You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it.
Get started with Bitcoin at bitcoin.com. It's bitcoin.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
Talk Live. You can join us here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Maybe you've got a story about a helicopter parent. One of these overprotective parents who just never stops with taking responsibility for their children's lives. They don't allow their kids to take their own responsibility for their life. And then when they get released to the world, or at least almost released to the world, they go to college. They're away, far enough away than they've ever, further away than they've ever been from their parents' home. The parents, some of them, will continue to attempt to hover on the college campus in various ways. But we're not really talking so much about the parents themselves. If you want to tell us a story, you're welcome to at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about what the effect is on the students, these supposed adults who are now, you know, the training wheels are coming off. They're at the college, and according to the story at freerangekids.com by Peter Gray, also published in Psychology Today, the school that he works for, they had a meeting where they talked about how emergency calls to counseling had more than doubled over the past 5 years. And Mark, you had talked about the idea that this has this phenomenon, if you will, the helicopter parenting or helicopter society in this case, that it has been on the rise over the last couple few decades. Sounds like just over the last 5 years, at least at this one school, it's been a dramatic increase in neediness of these students.
What happened 20 years ago, or you know, 20-something years ago, that caused this to happen? I don't know. I mean, I have no clue, but why is it that the kids born in 1997 are somehow less qualified to take care of themselves than those born in 1991?
I think awareness is the biggest thing.
Awareness of what?
Awareness that there are so many bad things that can happen. The media, of course, has if it bleeds, it leads. And the reporting, I would argue, probably the biggest story in CNN's early career was when the what was her name fell down the well. And then there was that whole story. That was like what kind of like made CNN that they had this 24-hour thing.
Interesting.
So like anything,
we're gonna know exactly when this little girl gets out of the well, kind of thing.
Yeah, and okay. So like or dies. Any time something happens to a child, and now with 24-hour news, there used to be, you know, every day you turn on the news at 6 p.m. or whatever, and then you'd hear the local news, then the national news. Now we have a 24/7/365 news cycle. It's always going. The reporting on these stories is just overwhelming.
Yeah.
Whenever anything happens.
That's as good enough a guess, I think, as anything else. I mean, the information society, not that bad things happen more often now. In fact, I think the statistics show they're less likely to occur. Violence is certainly down.
I've heard that too. Abductions are down.
But you hear about them when they do happen more often, and it seems more serious because you're hearing about it more often, and that can create some misunderstandings in people, which could result in college students who are calling the counseling department because they saw a mouse in their off-campus apartment. Two of them. Two students did this.
Why would you call the counseling center? What are they going to do? Talk to the mouse?
I don't know. Talk to the students, I guess. Calm them down. The latter two also called the police, who kindly arrived and set a mousetrap for them.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah.
This is like this is like the people who call 911 because they didn't get Chicken McNuggets through the drive-thru when they... Go ahead, Ian.
Faculty at the meetings noted that students' emotional fragility has become a serious problem when it comes to grading. Some had said they'd grown afraid to give low grades for poor performance because of the subsequent emotional crises they would have to deal with in their offices.
Now, this is to some extent, I would guess, the culture of everybody's a winner. Everybody gets a trophy, right? Like, you know, for some reason, kids just can't handle
it. You showed up.
Right? I can't handle some bullying or whatever it might be.
Well, bullying's not fun, right? Like,
it's not fun, but it's a reality, right? I mean, you're going to get bullied in life.
You know, it certainly is a reality at government school.
It's a reality on the show. You get beat up on a regular basis by me verbally.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah, well, what?
No, it's bullying when I cut your mic. Keep it up.
I just talked with some kids recently, and they were saying that bullying, that the only thing that they know about bullying now is from, like, 80s movies.
I don't believe it.
I couldn't believe it either. They said that the instance and the awareness of bullying is so high now that any time that bullying does happen, it gets reported and the kids get in trouble.
Hmm. Well, I
so
would say that's a good
thing.
He said
bullying doesn't happen at all, which
but what is bullying?
Is amazing.
This, like, where's the line? Can you good-naturedly mess with somebody that maybe you're, you know?
Okay, fine. I mean, I wouldn't call that bullying. Teasing somebody,
you
okay?
Wouldn't. But teasing is what a lot of people call bullying.
Stealing somebody's lunch money or physically attacking them generally is what I would consider.
I get it, but I don't think that that's where the line for bullying is.
I get what you're saying.
Well, I think part of the problem, too, is that now that teachers in schools are mandated reporters, like doctors and whatever, mm-hmm. that if they witness any...
If you see something, say something.
Exactly, that they can actually be on the hook for if
legally
because they're mandated reporters, they have to. So I think that question of where do you draw the line is something that's very
it's sending kids to a government school. I wouldn't do it. I think if you want your kids to encounter bullying, that's a place where they're much more likely to encounter it as opposed to if you're an unschooler, for
see,
instance.
You have you're comparing the two as though those are the only choices. There's lots of things in between. There's charter schools, there's private schools, there's regular homeschooling. There's a whole variety of things in between. And I went to the best private school in my town. My mother invested this because she wanted me to have the best opportunities and that sort of thing. It's certainly bullying that went
at
on
private
there.
Schools. Absolutely.
Yeah. So I mean,
yeah, any school where you're in a place where you know you're not in total control of who's there, you could possibly encounter bullying. And certainly, it can happen in real life, if you will. But I think it's certainly more likely to occur in a government or private school. In a situation like
the more kids you have in one location, the more likely you are to have bullying. Yes. Yeah.
If you're homeschooled and you're having a bullying problem, that's...
Yeah. If you have more than one kid, I'll bet you do.
Mom, I'm getting bullied.
Much of the discussions had to do with the amount of hand-holding faculty should do versus the degree to which the response should be something like, buck up, kid, this is college. Does the first response simply play into and perpetuate students' neediness and unwillingness to take responsibility? And does the second response create the possibility of serious emotional breakdown? Or, who knows, maybe even suicide? So Gray quotes some of the issues.
Right. Once the suicide occurs, whatever it was that is the media decides led to it, something is going to get changed, you know? Somebody has committed suicide because this staff member told them to act like an adult. And then suddenly, acting like an adult just no longer holds the appeal it once did.
Gray goes on to quote some of the issues that the head of counseling is seeing looming over the college, including these bullet points. Less resilient and needy students have shaped the landscape for faculty in that they are expected to do more handholding, lower their academic standards, and not challenge students too much.
Well, I mean, you know, what we're told as parents many times is that you got to give positive reinforcement to your kid. And this is a fun thing to do. I enjoy telling my kid that he's smart and good-looking and doing, you know, these great things. But I don't mind telling him when he's messed up, too, mm-hmm. and where he has failed to meet my expectations. I wonder whether or not some parents fail to do this. And if they, you know, if everybody believes they're a special little snowflake, that's going to...
Who can do no wrong.
Yeah. At some point or another, you're going to come to the conclusion that, hey, my parents lied to me. I am not a special little snowflake. Like, for instance, I have special little snowflakes that pull out in front of me in traffic all the time. I hate those special little snowflakes, right?
Students are afraid to fail. They
God,
do
I'd
not...
much rather do a show with Brian than you.
They do not take risks. They need to be certain about things.
Somebody's going to laugh at your bad joke. Touché.
For many of them, failure is seen as catastrophic and unacceptable. External measures of success are more important than learning and autonomous development. They don't take risks. They are afraid to fail. And that's kind of the way the system is set up. It's set up to encourage people to not take risks. Like, okay, just go to college, get a job, and then pay off your college loans forever, and then someday you'll retire.
The government should pay off the school loans now. Don't you know that's the whole thing, Hillary Clinton? And
I can't blame someone for wanting that to happen, because college loans are a terrible burden.
Another vote-buying program. Yeah. Yay!
Our toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you work at a college, you've experienced this, or you attend and you see it in some of your co-students.
Maybe you just need a hug.
You want to share your thoughts with us here, 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's EATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
My dad was 59 when he collapsed from a heart attack late last year. Just this past August was when we spread his ashes on the St. Croix River. I loved my dad, but boy was he stubborn. He hadn't been to the doctor in over 25 years. His excuse? He simply couldn't afford it. He wasn't a rich man by any means. At less than $107 per month, LibertyOnCall.org would have been the perfect alternative for my father. Don't wait. Go to LibertyOnCall.org right now. For not just your sake, but for the sake of your loved ones. Again, that's LibertyOnCall.org.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us on the radio waves here. The toll-free number for you is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And if you've got a small business, then you know
like we do.
How much of a pain in the butt
like I don't.
Business cards can be. It can be a pain to, and it can be expensive to order business cards. But not if you use our code over at Vistaprint.com. First of all, Vistaprint is very affordable without the Free Talk Live discount code. But if you use code FTL at Vistaprint.com, you'll get 500 business cards. That'll get you started with your business for just $9.99. And that's up to a 50% savings over the regular site pricing. It's a fantastic deal. They've got tons of layouts and design options for you. You can just plug your information in and go. Or if you're a graphics pro, you can just upload your own graphic designs. I did that. I made a Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree card, and it was super easy.
You made
easy.
It yourself?
Well, I mean, I hired someone to do the graphics, okay. And then I made it on, I uploaded those graphics through the Vistaprint tool, and they have this online tool that makes it super easy to do your own cards.
Right, because I was going to say, when you said that it's difficult to get business cards put together, I'm like, it's not that difficult. It's just expensive because it turn it over to somebody else and they give you a proof and you're like, okay, that's fine. And then they send it out, and by the time you're done, it's $200. In this case, they've got the design tools right online, and it costs you $9.99.
That's where it starts when you use code FTL at Vistaprint.com, and you can customize everything about the card. You can upload your logo or draw, you can use their tools online to design your card. They've got all kinds of neat things that you can do to them, like metallic finishes, spot gloss, raised print, fancy stuff too. So you don't have to go the basic route, but the basic cards, you can get them for just $9.99 over at Vistaprint.com. 500 of them with code FTL. So go to Vistaprint.com and order today. As we go to your calls and thoughts here, let's go to Aaron, listening in Indianapolis. Aaron, are we actually on the radio in Indy tonight, or are you online?
I'm online.
Okay, very good. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, I don't know. You guys are talking about helicopter parents, and I've got two young boys of my own, 3 and 18 months, and I was actually thinking my wife may be a helicopter parent.
Why is that?
And, it sounds like one of them just jumped off the bunk bed.
I don't know. It's like something like, oh, my God, they're in the street, and oh, my God, don't let them run like that, or, running across the laminate floor with socks on.
Oh, my God.
That sounds like fun to me.
She's got a sister who's actually probably a little worse, and she's even into, eating organic and, whole foods and stuff like that.
I think this is the new religion of the new millennium, because my wife got into it, too.
The organic stuff?
She had, it was nothing like that before Jack was born, mm-hmm. but then suddenly everything's got to be fine. The new cleaners have to be green cleaners. We can't have the regular cleaners, because who knows, he might chug some Woolite or whatever. I don't know.
That way your kids throw up as green.
If it gives you where I'm at, we just had fish sticks and canned green beans.
Yeah.
So
how old are the kids? 8 or 9, you said?
No, one is 3 and the other's about 18 months.
I don't know where the hell I got 8 and 9 from. So your wife has been this way through the entire time thus far?
Yes.
Or?
Yeah, you know, she's scared to God that they're going to have SIDS, and, you know, now they're going to have something.
Sudden infant death syndrome?
Sudden infant death syndrome, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's, sudden infant death syndrome. And, I mean, I'm not saying that's not, you know, like a legitimate concern, because obviously you want to take practical steps, but letting it be an all-consuming thing is just, you know, yeah, she couldn't sleep at night. She'd, get up and, you know, go hide outside
Poor
their
thing.
Door, making sure they were breathing and stuff.
I know the feeling that she feels. I totally appreciate it. I mean... Oh, poor thing.
So how do you ride that line? How do you ride that line of making sure that you're, you know, sympathizing with the way that she feels, but at the same time kind of making sure she stays within reality?
Yeah. Well, and I think she's, I mean, not like, she's functional, I guess I'll say that, which just this line of functional. And if one other thing, if I could kind of offer some thoughts on, you were talking about the children being an investment. Like financially with, you know, paying for their health care and everything else. And I was almost thinking that whenever I look at them, I look at it as an investment, like in a Darwinian sense.
That's about all,
know,
because...
Meaning keeping the human race going kind of an investment?
They never pay off.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know what it is, you know, we're all basically just trying to pass our genes along, like, you know, law of the jungle. You've got to get out there and mate as much as you can.
Aaron,
and,
thank you for sharing your call and thoughts tonight. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
You're not trying to pass on your genes?
No, I have a vasectomy.
Yeah.
That's
why
impossible.
Why did you do that?
We all appreciate
what's the
it,
deal
buddy.
With that?
Well, I don't want kids, so why would I not, you know, want to have a vasectomy?
But why don't you want to have kids? You don't want your genes to live on forever like the caller?
Yeah, I just don't have that drive, I guess. I mean, why would I care?
It's kind of not too many people think like that. It's kind of interesting.
I think that it's responsible in the sense that, wow, you know, he's not going to get caught in that situation that oh so many guys get caught in, which is that
knocking someone up, you mean?
Yeah, well, you know.
Yeah, I mean, that was probably the main...
I hear it happens, buddy.
Yeah, but that was probably the main concern for me was I didn't want to end up having a kid I didn't want to have. And so that's a way to prevent that from happening is if you just go ahead and snip your vas deferens tubes. That'll take care of the problem.
99 times out of 100, it will.
It's more than probably 99 out of 100. It's a fairly successful operation that generally doesn't reverse itself. It's probably more like 1 out of 10,000 times or something.
Well,
like that.
Why not just the traditional types of contraceptions, though? Why not you?
That's expensive if you think about it, right? So, like, if you don't want kids.
I guess it depends on how often you're using them.
If you don't want kids.
In his case, I think he might have got it done before he ever actually had sex with somebody.
That's not true.
No, how many? Okay, is it one? What
I had
number
one girlfriend, but I'd had sex a few times before that.
Oh my God, Ian's had sex. That's awesome.
Thanks. Appreciate that.
Congratulations. That's high five.
But you know, you have sex several hundred times, and you paid for a lot of condoms there, and you know the vas
buy
the vasectomy
at Costco.
Was
Costco,
only $700.
By the pallet. So.
Well, sex without a condom is certainly better than sex with one. I think pretty much everyone
will
agree.
Yeah, I tried one
it's
once,
the same.
And
it's
I want
the,
nothing to do with that.
The only thing worse than a condom is getting a social disease, really.
So, anyway, back to other. Speaking of people that have sex in an unsafe manner, college students. We're back on that story here from Free Range Kids, talking about how they're... The term they're using here is that there's a decline in resilience, meaning that when something happens in the student's life, something as simple as a roommate calling another a bitch, or students who have seen a mouse in their off-campus apartment calling campus counseling services over these issues. Just as a few examples.
We had rats at Northeastern. I went to Northeastern in Boston. We had rats the size of cats.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, and they would run through the quads and whatever. It was disgusting.
God.
They were enormous. I'm not exaggerating.
Well, like fed, I imagine.
Like the size of a squirrel. And
you didn't bother buying a rat trap?
No.
Never even considered
the
it.
The only thing that we would maybe ever do is call up building services and say, hey, we have
There's lots of rats.
Can you take care of it? We never called up the counseling center. We're like, my feelings are hurt because we have rats. What am I going to do?
That's pretty much what we did at the radio station that we started working at. With,
what's
that? You know, at some point or another, there had been enough complaints about the rats that they tried to do something about it.
They did, yeah. Wow. They set a bunch of traps in the ceiling. They caught about 40.
They finally had to just knock the building down.
Holy jeez.
Yeah, it was bad. I remember one night coming into the break room, and there was a rat just sitting on the trash can lid. Laying in there, eating something.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say he was talking into the mic.
It could have been that
way. When they
way.
Turn around and look at you and, like, dare you to do something about it, that's that's when there's a problem.
You got a problem? Yeah.
And I think they took took 36 rats out or something like that on the first
wow.
trapping run. And then they did another one after that. I think
wow.
they got caught several
did you hear
more.
Them running around in there?
Usually the rats are just working on sales. Oh, I'm just...
Yeah. Poor sales guys.
Faculty, particularly...
They drive better cars than you do.
Particularly damn young right. faculty members feel pressured to accede to student wishes lest they get low teacher ratings from their students. Students email about...
Teacher ratings? What the hell is that?
Oh, you don't know? You can rate your teachers online now.
I had forgotten that this even existed.
Did you hear about that app that came out recently? You can rate other
people. I haven't tried it, but I did hear about it.
There's a new
Yelp thing. It's so weird.
Have you tried it?
No, but I mean, at the end of the day, everybody's going to have their own opinions. I'm sure we could go back through my history and people like me, people hate me.
Right.
Whatever. It's just like Yelp reviews.
It's inevitable.
Everybody's going to have different opinions.
Students will email the staff about trivial things and expect prompt replies.
like an instant message back.
There's more here about college students. And the story here from freerangekids.com says here they're falling apart thanks to this helicopter society. And maybe you have a story to share in regards to this or whatever happens to be on your mind.
Let's all hug during the break.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It's not a bad idea. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
When the most powerful and destructive witch in 13th century France chooses a successor, her frightened young protege, Lyanna, escapes into the wild. Pursued by witch hunters, the town watch, and her mistress, Lyanna's only hope is a pair of newly returned crusaders, one with PTSD, the other a complete rascal. The Witch's Hand by Wendy Joseph is a cut above the usual sword and sorcery fare. Available now at your favorite booksellers or visit WendyJosephWrites.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, October 5th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.40 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,135 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $239.
Antiwar.com reports while the White House is making it clear they are opposed to Russian airstrikes against the Islamic State, those strikes are being met with growing statements of support from top U.S. allies in the war. On Friday, the Syrian Kurdish faction of the YPG endorsed Russia, unsurprising as they are often allies of the Assad government in fighting the Islamic State. On Saturday, the Iraqi Kurds echoed that support. A new statement from President Masoud Barzani of Iraq's Kurdistan Regional Government says that he welcomes the assistance of any country, including Russia, in the battle against the Islamic State, and hopes Russia will support the Peshmerga forces in their fights against the Islamic State. Barzani's statement also included a call for the U.S. to coordinate with Russia on their fight against the Islamic State, something U.S. officials have repeatedly ruled out, saying they believe the war against the Islamic State would be much more effective if everyone was working together. Russia offered coordination with the U.S. ahead of their strikes and urged the U.S. to join a new intelligence-sharing endeavor in Baghdad, though the U.S. has refused. Barzani's endorsement may also reflect growing support for Russia across Iraq in general. The U.S. and the Abadi government haven't been on the best of terms recently, and their new coziness with Russia may be a decent bargaining chip when dealing with the U.S. Though the Kurdish Peshmerga has been arguably the closest U.S. ally throughout the war, the group has accepted aid from other groups, even those the U.S. is not on good terms with. Among the first nations to provide the Peshmerga with arms was Iran. Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co. UPI reports the U.S. Department of Defense said it is considering three Colorado prisons as potential sites to house terrorism suspects detained at the military prison in Guantanamo Bay, Cuba. The Pentagon plans to send a team to locations in Colorado, including the so-called Supermax or ADX Florence prison, home to some of the country's most notorious criminals, including Unabomber Ted Kaczynski and Oklahoma City bomber Terry Nichols. Military officials announced they plan a visit to the medium-sized federal prison near ADX Florence and a state-run maximum security prison about 10 miles away, the Colorado State Penitentiary. The trip is intended to determine if any of the facilities will be suitable to transfer some of the Guantanamo detainees, but it will also help officials understand the potential cost of moving the detainees to similar facilities across the United States. The idea has prompted immediate pushback from Colorado lawmakers who say federal statutes bar them from bringing detainees onto U.S. soil.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports search and rescue teams on Sunday located debris appearing to belong to the cargo ship El Faro, which went missing in the eye of the Hurricane Joaquin, with 33 mostly American crew members aboard more than 3 days ago, according to the U.S. Coast Guard and the ship's owner. Tim Nolan, president of the ship's owner, Tote Maritime Puerto Rico, said in a statement there was no sighting of El Faro or any of its lifeboats. With no word on the fate of the crew, relatives gathered at a Seafarers Union hall in Jacksonville, Florida, where they were briefed by the Coast Guard and the ship's owner. Late Sunday, the Coast Guard tweeted that the debris field covered 225 miles and included styrofoam, wood, cargo, and other items. The Coast Guard could not confirm that the object belonged to the ship, which sent a distress signal on Thursday morning in the Bahamas, but has not been heard from since. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Shortly after creating a profile on OkCupid.com, local man Malcolm Lighty, a person with severe psychological and emotional issues, told reporters he thought it was best to just never mention the fact there was something seriously wrong with him on the popular dating website.
The thing about online dating is you don't want to get too personal too quickly. Like, for example, how I'm a textbook narcissist with unresolved intimacy issues, or the fact that I have no sense of empathy. Nobody wants to hear about that. When you're making a first impression, it's important that you keep it casual and don't include too much information. You don't want to be talking about your inability to maintain a relationship because of a history of violent mood swings.
Lighty told reporters while his OkCupid profile includes extensive details about his favorite movies, love of cooking, and interest in cars, he thought he was, quote, just better off not mentioning the borderline personality disorder that makes it impossible for him to connect with another person on any kind of meaningful level.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio, you've got me, Ian.
Brian Henchy.
And Mark.
And you can also join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Coming up later, we'll talk about the right to die. Apparently that right has expanded to a new state in the United States, and we'll get into that. But in the first hour of the show, and continuing now, because I think this is an important topic, college students and their lack of resilience, a stunning decline in their resilience, according to Peter Gray. He's the author of Free to Learn, and he's being quoted here over at freerangekids.com by Lenore Scanese. Great blog, by the way. Anyway, she posts most of his essay that he wrote for Psychology Today about his experience on a college campus as an administrator or faculty member of some sort, going to a meeting where they talked about how the students on campus have, over the last 5 years, been doubling their emergency calls to the counseling services department for such matters as important as being called a bitch by a roommate and seeing a mouse in an off-campus apartment. So just to give you a couple of the examples that they're experiencing here, they come together, or they've come up with a few bullet points, that a few observations about all this. One of them is these college students are failing and struggling. Failure and struggle need to be normalized. Students are very uncomfortable in not being right. We have to normalize being wrong and learning from one's errors. So the students don't like being wrong. They don't like being told that they're wrong. Earlier, we were...
I don't like it much either.
Better not get married.
We were earlier, we were told that the students, the teachers, I guess, are being encouraged to give them higher grades simply because the teachers don't want to deal with the students freaking out and having an emotional crisis of some sort over the fact that they got a poor grade. So just the reactions of the students are so extreme now to being given negative feedback or a negative grade of some sort that the teachers are less likely to give the negative feedback or grades simply because they don't want to deal with the outburst that might come as a result of that.
I got to be honest. I mean, I'm not a visual artist at all. I suck at visual art. Never been good at it. I had a teacher in middle school who tore my head off because he would say, "Oh, this is terrible. This sucks," and it really hurt my feelings. And I think my parents had a conversation with him, whatever, and he said, "Well, that's how he was, you know, taught, whatever." But I think if anything,
so
now
this
there's
is like an art teacher.
Yeah, yeah, okay. This was an art teacher, and I remember he used to smoke cigarettes in the classroom, and he'd turn on the fan because that would suck out all the paint fumes, and he thought nobody would notice that he was smoking cigarettes in the classroom.
I was gonna say, man, you got to be a lot older than me if your teacher was smoking cigarettes in the classroom.
He was. Well, yeah, yeah, but yeah, when nobody was there. Yeah, but the thing is, that's like one extreme, but now we're at the way other extreme where to not even give negative feedback. I mean, not everybody deserves, you know, to pass.
Well, and in the government schools, you're forced to take art. You're forced to take music. You're forced to take computers.
But you should get the it should be merit based. You should get what you deserve in terms of your feedback. You shouldn't be getting grades that you didn't earn.
Well, you shouldn't have to take.
What value is passing if everybody passes?
Exactly.
But I agree with all that. But what I'm saying is you shouldn't have to take art.
you know, you knew you didn't, you weren't good at art. You weren't interested probably in getting better at art.
But who knows if I may have discovered something about myself that maybe I did have a talent in that. I have no problem, you know, in hindsight, looking back, that I tried this.
Yeah, but if you are terrible at it and then all you're getting is abused verbally by the teacher, verbal abuse is the problem, though?
Not the being forced to try something new.
Agreed.
I mean, you know, hey, kid, why don't you try this? Is not a terrible thing to do at your school.
Sure, but
and this is one of the complaints I have sort of about unschooling and that sort of thing, mm-hmm. is that many times kids, there's just some kids that aren't that adventurous. They're not going to try new things. Well, sometimes everybody, people, not kids, people need a kick in the butt and get told, you know, go try this. You know, eat that lima bean, or you're not going to be able to play with your iPad tonight. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes kids need that. And you know, the special little snowflakes of this world, they're not getting
these.
When's
the last time you had lima beans?
I eat lima beans all the time. They're terrible.
They're horrible. They're terrible.
I still think they're one of the worst beans.
Cucumbers, I will not eat.
Okay, there you go.
I love cucumbers.
Everybody does. Everybody's like, they don't taste like anything.
They're boring.
They're just fresh.
They're boring.
People use this terminology. I'm like, this is the most infectious, rude fruit available.
Rude?
Rude.
Rude?
It looks like a big giant, and you know what, and it's green and bumpy,
what about guacamole?
Everything it touches, guacamole.
It's like puke. Avocados.
Yeah, that's avocados.
Well, okay, yeah.
But everything they touch tastes like cucumbers after they touch it. Blah!
I don't know.
Green peppers are the same way.
I like green peppers, too. I don't even like vegetables in general.
I like them better now.
So far, everything you've mentioned, I really like. Well, except lima beans.
I feel like green peppers spoil the taste of whatever it is.
Everybody's got their thing. But you wouldn't know if you didn't try it.
Yeah, that's true.
And that's like, I don't like olives, but every couple of years, I'll try olives again to see if my taste buds have changed.
Did your mother change over time.
That's a good thing to do.
Did your mother lie to you and tell you that every 7 years your taste buds change?
Let me tell you, my mom would lie to us. We were forced to eat liver when I was growing up, and my mother would lie to us because we were, ew, liver, ew, and it's still gross, and she'd lie to us and say that it was steak, and we were like, no, this is not steak. We saw right through her BS. We knew that she was lying to
us.
But liver is disgusting.
Yeah, I think there was a time when it was acceptable to lie to children.
Sardines.
Lots of parents lie to their kids. That's all Santa Claus is.
I knew you'd whip out Santa Claus.
But what, okay, so you guys, I think it's safe to say, are against victimless crimes, yes?
Sure. Yeah,
yes,
sure.
That's true.
What
yeah.
is the crime? Where is the victim when it comes to, you know, at the Tooth Fairy and Santa Claus and all that
stuff?
Oh,
it's no crime. You're just lying to your kids. I
mean, yeah.
That happens a lot.
That happens a lot.
I think that there's a line.
But there's no harm done by that.
At some point, there's a trust issue. It depends on how far you take it. So you know, as a young inquisitive kid, I'm like, this Santa Claus thing cannot be true. My mom's stuck with the line, right? She's like, yes, there's a Santa Claus. Indeed, there's a Santa Claus.
Would she go so far as to like leave out the half-eaten cookies or whatever you leave cookies for Santa Claus?
My dad would definitely eat those cookies.
Yeah.
he's got no problem. He'll eat the cookies. This is back when Soft Batch first came out.
Okay.
I don't even know if they still make those awful
things.
They do,
I think. Yeah.
And
you don't like Soft Batch?
I took the letter to Santa Claus.
Man, you're a hater, man.
Slid it in the
no
mailbox
idea.
Myself. No one knew.
Do you hate ice cream too?
No, I love that stuff.
Oh, God. Do you hate fun?
He's been pretty grumpy tonight, I gotta say.
So I sent out the letter on my own, so she didn't get to see what was on my Christmas list. I actually got nothing on it, but then she leaves a note from Santa Claus that says, hey, I didn't have the things you were looking for. Sorry, you know, check with me next year. That kind of thing. So then I'm still wondering. I'm left with this kind of betrayal's a really strong word, but
dear
confusion.
Mark, you were a horrible child this year, therefore you're not getting what you want, Santa.
So wait, you sent it in the mail?
P.S. Screw you.
And so the mailman got it, presumably, and
it just goes to that place where letters to Santa goes.
Okay.
Yeah, just shredded or burned or whatever they do with them. I have no idea. Sorry, kids.
What do you do with the mail? If there's any postal workers out there.
Yeah, they got dead-end stuff. I don't know where they go. But that's the internet will answer that question for you. So ultimately, I was left wondering. I think that if I would have been, like the year before,
how old
it would have been
you?
Fine.
How long were they continuing the lie? Until
I think it was 7 years
age?
Old. It would have been my guess.
Really? Did they pop it on you, or had you already kind of figured it out?
I was wondering. I had tried to figure this out. My first theory was there's no possibility that Santa Claus makes this whole trip in 24 hours. And I thought it was just one night because I didn't really understand time zones.
This just proves Mark's been a buzzkill since he was 7.
So I'm figuring that there must be a Santa Claus for every town. And so I'm figuring Because you heard about Santa's helpers, and you knew that the guy sitting at the mall,
a guy in the mall and
had
a guy,
fake beard.
It's his elves, right?
So I was
you could see a guy in the mall, in theory, on the same day as seeing a different Santa Claus downtown or something like that. Right,
so you knew that there were at least people faking it as Santa down, you know, at the mall. So are these the ones that are breaking and entering into your house and leaving strange things? You know, I don't know the answer to that. So as a young person, I'm trying to find that out. And I would have been just a lot better off if I would have been told a year before, this is the last year we're going to do it for you. And I hope you have fun and don't ruin it for the other kids, because this is about fun. Because my inquisitive
mind... And
Mark
is like, you lie!
It was just too much for me.
855-450-FREE.
You can't handle the truth.
855-450-3733. You
want
can join
answers?
Us.
I've got answers.
You can tell us your Santa Claus story or your experience in college. Anything goes here on Free Talk Live, or join us on Skype at lrn.fm.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at Credit Success Secrets Revealed. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek. But there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine, so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love,
and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way,
love as your guide,
and liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Join us on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. Whether you want to talk about these overprotected college students and how that is manifesting itself in apparently a lot more calls to what is called the Counseling Services Department at one particular college where they had a staff meeting recently to talk about this problem. Students are seeking increasingly seeking help for and apparently having emotional crises over problems of everyday life. So you're welcome to tell your story in relation to that. Maybe you've worked at a college, you've attended college with some of these overprotected kids. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Also, your Santa Claus story, if you want to share what that was like. Mark was just telling us about his experience in having the wool pulled off of his eyes in that particular case. And you're welcome to share your thoughts also via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Mark, tell me about what one can read that will be of interest.
Yeah, it's James versus the New World Order. And I'm a big fan of sort of libertarianism in fiction, because I think that we can get the ideas better. It's more entertaining. People consume entertainment much more than they do sort of being preached at. So James versus the New World Order is an action comedy graphic novel by Brandon Bitros and illustrated by J. Matthew Root, the first in what's estimated to be a 5-volume, 24-issue series. So what would you do if a bizarre occult army calling itself the Trust invaded your sleepy little mountain hometown? We can find out what James Cantrell, a big-hearted country boy with a crappy job who's learned to live without dreams, does, because sometimes the guy who's learned to live without dreams might be the best suited to handle a nightmare. If this intrigues you, go to jamesversusthenewworldorder.com, and you can pre-order your graphic novel. They've got a Kickstarter campaign going there, but really the intention is to get the money together for artwork, coloring, production, distribution. There's not much that they're trying to put together, but a pre-order certainly help in creating this. jamesvsthenewworldorder.com. It's jamesversusthenewworldorder.com.
All right, let's go to your calls and thoughts. Charlie's listening in Arizona to K-Talks. Hey, Charlie, you're on with Ian, Brian, Henschy, and Mark.
Well, good evening, my friends. I just wanted to talk about the societal movement towards, and it's not just for kids, but as the kids grow, it progresses into the adult society. I was lucky enough to meet a free-range kid, it was years ago, and, you know, it was definitely a country setting, but I, as a young person, I climbed the mountain behind my house.
I wonder if you're more likely to find free-range kids in the country versus in the city. It seems like maybe you could jump to the conclusion fairly safely that this is a phenomenon that affects more urban youth. Do you think that's true today?
Oh, I definitely think so. And your comments on everybody being a winner, I was an Eagle Scout before I turned 16, and I learned a lot in the program, and I think that political correctness has pretty much ruined the program.
What part Eagle of that? Scouting has been ruined by political correctness.
Yeah, well, how's that the case?
Well, I don't think, you know, it's comes to the point where you're saying everybody needs to win, and when I was in
but not
Scout,
everybody is an Eagle Scout. I mean, that's a pretty hard thing to
win. You've won once you become an Eagle Scout, I think.
No, I mean, that's a hard thing to win. There's a lot of work going into this. I mean, I never got past the level of Boy Scout. I didn't even get the Boy Scout badge when I joined, but I had a couple friends who did.
I only made it to the really inappropriately named Weeblos.
Yeah, I think that's where I made it to, Weeblos.
Yeah, between Cub Scouts and Boy Scouts. But everything, you know, the merit badges and whatnot, you had to earn them. And as you said, it was a lot of work.
Well, wait, do they just hand out the merit badges now? You don't have to earn them anymore?
I think the requirements are much less. I don't know. Last time I was really involved is I was a shooting sports director.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you, is how long has it been? Because, I mean, are you just speculating, or do you have some personal experience that it is an easier thing to gain these merit badges?
Well, just from conversations that I've had with people along the way, it seems to me that is the situation now.
Well, thank you for the call tonight, Charlie. I appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and maybe you are involved with or have been involved with the Boy Scouts in the last, let's say, decade. Have things been, are they worse now as far as it's easier to be a scout, meaning that, you know, the bar has been lowered across the board, so to speak, for all these various different merit badges and such? If you've got comments you want to share, go ahead. 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Aaron. He's in Philly via Skype. Hello, Aaron.
Hey, guys. I was just, I posted an article to your website today, and no one else seemed to care, but it seemed important to me. There's okay. There's some people over in China that have started making transgenic pigs.
What's that mean? Transgenic? What is a transgenic pig?
So they're modifying them so that they remove a gene responsible for creating a growth hormone, so they become micro pigs, like
the little
size of
piggies.
A small dog.
Oh, cool.
Do they taste any better? That's really what I want to know. Is the bacon still delicious? Or
they're selling them as pets. So
they're going to cost more than a regular pig, and they're going to produce far less bacon.
Yeah, they're going to cost about $1,300, but you get to choose the size and color of your pig.
How big are we talking about? What's the maximum size?
I think you're talking about 5 to 10 pounds, like these.
That's
little...
so small.
Whoa! I thought I heard this article, and they were talking about them topping out at 45 pounds. A pig is a dense little thing, and so I would, even if they're small, they're going to be pretty heavy.
You know what? I could be off by a little bit. The picture I saw with the article looks like
it's a tiny little baby pig. Yeah.
Yeah. And it was. Anyways, I was wondering.
45 pounds is a small animal as far as a pig goes. I mean, it's
like a tenth the size of one of your pigs,
it's
right?
It's a bit bigger than it's a lot less. Yeah.
Don't you have a 400-pound pig?
I have a 550-pound pig. Yeah.
Wow.
It's going to be a bit bigger than a football, but not much bigger.
Wow. Yeah, I'm seeing here 30 pounds.
Watermelon
is approximate size.
That's really cool, I think.
But is that how do you feel about that ethically? Are we committing a violence against the pig by doing this to it?
Tweaking genetics, basically?
Is it a violation of what it is?
Which pig are we committing violence against? Because at this point, you can't have
a pig that doesn't exist.
Right, there's no crime against humanity. There's only a crime against individuals. So which pig has the crime committed against it?
The one that's been hobbled to never grow past 30 pounds.
But couldn't you argue that same sort of thing's been done through breeding with dogs?
Sure,
because lots of dogs have been bred to be very small.
Yeah, but each breeding event's voluntary. This is the first time.
Not for the dog, necessarily.
Well, necessarily the female dog, but generally for the male dog, it's a voluntary act.
Hold that thought, Aaron. Hold that thought. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's
855. I can tell you, female pigs are the ones that will tear down the fence to get to the male.
Yeah, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733.
I've known some pigs like that.
This is Free Talk Live, and your thoughts on messing with the genetics of a pig.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
My name is Dell, and I live in El Cajon, California. I was concerned about my cholesterol readings because I knew that high cholesterol is related to clogging of the arteries and increases the risk for heart attack and stroke. One day, I heard an ad for Heart and Body Extract, and I was skeptical, but I decided to give it a try. Man, the numbers don't lie.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at HBExtract.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Monday, gold is $3 higher at $1,142 per ounce. Silver is up 42 cents at $15.73 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $238. Looking for silver? We have plenty of Australian silver spiders and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free. Is there something wrong with the idea of genetically modified pigs or some other animal for that matter? Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Apparently, there's news that has come out recently about a group in China, the Beijing Genomics Institute, BGI. There's a lot of stories about this. This is from sciencealert.com. They have announced that thanks to the wonders of gene editing, they have tiny pigs, micro pigs, that are engineered to grow to be as big as a medium-sized dog. So we've heard maybe 35, 45 pounds as the maximum range, the gene-edited
pigs. Well, pot-belly pigs, people might be thinking of those.
Or teacup pigs. They small sound very small, but they're actually not.
Well, one thing that you have to be careful of, a teacup pig sort of describes a pig's condition today. It may not describe how that pig is going to look in a year.
Right. They all get big until now.
Apparently. Well, some they've managed to breed pigs down to a reasonable size. Some
when you
of
say
them,
reasonable, what do you mean? 100 pounds?
100 pounds is a, I mean, people
it's
have 100-pound dogs.
Yeah, it's still a big animal.
It's a big animal, and it's stronger than a dog.
You don't hear 100-pound dogs being called cute, generally, right? Like, they're not a little thing that prances about like a tiny pig would.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, indeed. I mean, the smaller the pig, the more people are going to like it. I watch right. out because small animals tend to be a little surly. You know,
is that right?
They got little Napoleon complexes. But if these are pleasant little animals.
I didn't know that was true of all animals. I mean,
I just said tend.
Okay.
Toll-free number if you want to join us here is 855-450-FREE. Also, coming up October 29th and 30th, you'll be able to join Mark in Vegas. That's coming up fast.
Yeah, I hate the idea of heading out to Vegas for a convention October 29th and 30th for the Bitcoin Investor Conference. It's
sounds like hell.
Yeah, it's going to be awful. At the Beautiful D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas, they do take Bitcoin there, and it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm excited. Dr. Stephanie Murphy, former co-host here. Brian Sovereign, also a former co-host. Bitcoin Bell, another former co-host. It's going to be like a convention. There's going to be more co-hosts on Free Talk Live than there are here on a given night. Also, great speakers like Trace Mayer, Tone Vase, Paul Pui. Stephen Michaels is putting it on, and he's going to be speaking too. It's the Bitcoin Investor Conference. You can get your tickets. Please do get them now. This is our first event out in Las Vegas, live event. And I'm excited. Please come out and take a look. Bitcoininvestor.com.
All right. So it was actually Aaron in Philadelphia, who is still on the line via Skype, who brought this story to our attention here tonight of the micro pigs that, according to the story at sciencealert.com, 15 kilograms, so just under 35 pounds, is supposedly the maximum weight of one of these things. And they're going to be retailing at about $1,600 US a piece. And Aaron, can you kind of recap the question that you were asking tonight about the morality of this?
Yeah. Is this an act of aggression against the unborn pig to modify what it's going to be before it ever gets a chance?
Well, so, what do you think?
Make a case for that.
And when does anything, when it's in vitro, get to make choices?
Yeah, right.
So it's always a matter of degrees, right? I think I could get you to agree if you did this to a human child that would be an act of aggression against the would-be child.
I don't know if I would agree.
What if you bred a human child to not have legs?
Right.
Would you consider that to be an aggression, Ian? I mean,
I don't know. That's an interesting question.
Yeah, it's weird
That's
behavior.
That's pretty weird. That'd be pretty cruel.
I don't know if you can have prenatal aggression, but it's an interesting question.
Well, I mean, okay, so a lot of libertarians would say abortion is prenatal aggression. That's okay. Clear, right? Okay. Anyway, it's a matter – I feel like there's a line at some point where – you get far enough away from yourself in the food web where it's no longer aggression and everybody has their line, and then we have aggression past that point. And I'm just, this is kind of one of those things that kind of gets close to home because the pig's genetics are so close to humans that we're able to even, I mean, the first heart transplant was done from a pig to a human. They're very similar and they're analyzing tons and tons of data. This company is putting out 25% of the world's genomic data. And it's not that they won't have the capability soon. It's how close to the human species can we do this? Can we do this to monkeys? Can we do this?
They did it to Gary Coleman.
So, with humans, people would be able to modify the color of one's eyes or hair or tone of skin or things like that, right? Like, I mean, is that what we would see here? Are we talking about like mini humans, people that don't grow any higher than, like, 3 feet or
like
something?
Like mini me.
Like, what are we talking about?
What about people that just never age? Like, they're always babies.
What about
is that possible?
Like, more than mini.
What about kids that are compliant? What about kids that lack aggressive capability?
Yeah, I mean, these are all very interesting questions. And here's another, I guess, variant on the question. Okay, let's take away the idea that you can modify genes prior to birth and, you know, create this child that you want to create. What about, you know, you brought up this legs question mark. What about a baby that you can see in the womb? It's not going to have legs. Just for whatever freak happenstance, it just isn't growing legs in the womb, so you're SOL. Is it aggression to have that baby?
No, because if you're standing around and you see an automobile accident, mm-hmm. it's not your, you know, you have no sort of obligation. Now, if you do something, you throw a banana peel out there, the car speeds out of control, then you've done something. There's nothing immoral about being in a coma. So a person who does nothing cannot be held responsible, you know, in a moral sense.
But if the idea is that by preventing a child from having legs, to make that choice to, okay, I don't want my kid to have legs, is somehow aggression, isn't it the same thing to have a child that you know is not going to have legs? Because the idea is they would be at a disadvantage, right?
Yeah,
because
sure.
They don't have legs. So you are purposefully having a child that does not have legs. If it has happened naturally, that's okay?
I don't. Are you saying that murdering? Well, how about people that don't have legs? Is killing them better for them? Is that what you are suggesting?
So I'm not saying that I have an opinion about what you know this is. I don't know. I think this is an interesting question. But I, you know, it's your kids, so shouldn't you be able to form them in the way that you want to?
Or maybe a slightly different but related question would be, what about like Andrew Breitbart, who is a guy I have had a lot of respect for? That guy, his family history was that they had heart conditions and that they were dropped dead at about age, whatever, 45 or 50. Is it wrong to procreate when you know that basically on your medical history that your offspring is going to die early? Is that immoral or unethical or whatever, to procreate when you know there's a great likelihood that your kid is going to drop dead early, much earlier than he ought to?
I don't think so.
I don't know.
I mean,
I don't think it is.
I think that...
definitely a strange area.
It's the closest to the line, though, Brian. I don't know. I mean, you know, ultimately, I would say that there's no aggression against the pig in this circumstance.
But what about the human being?
The human being, it's a much more difficult question to answer.
What if you have a mini pig without legs?
Do you think this is an avenue we should be pursuing? Should we be allowed to just...
You're not going to stop it.
Genetics,
yeah, there's nothing you can do. You can't. I mean, there's no way to stop the mad scientist from doing some experiments. So I guess the best thing that you can do is just keep it all above board and let people know what's going on in the scientific community.
Thanks, Aaron, for your call tonight. I appreciate it. The gene-edited micro pigs is from ScienceAlert.com. Were originally created for research purposes, but will be marketed for $1,600 a piece. According to Nature, when fully mature, these micro pigs grow to about 15 kilograms, which could make them attractive to many a household pet, or too many as a household pet. Announcing the venture at Shenzhen International Biotech Leaders Summit last week, their technical director of animal science, Yang Li, said that the price tag was a commercial experiment to, quote, help us better evaluate the market. And I gotta say, $1,600 for a unique pig like that, or at least, you know, what feels unique for now, but ultimately may become a craze, $1,600 seems like, you know, that's well within the range of those expensive dogs or whatever,
right?
We
should get them as a sponsor. You know, next five callers get a free micro pig.
Maybe I'll get one when my dog passes.
My mother is a dog breeder, or was a dog breeder when I was younger, and now sort of shows dogs and that sort of thing. Doesn't want to handle breeding them any longer. But yeah, I mean, $1,600 would, if you say had a champion bloodline and a dog that was maybe finished or something like that, yeah, you could get $1,600.
Well, plus you get to totally customize it. Apparently, you can not only just have the pint-sized pig, but you'll be able to choose from a range of different coat colors and patterns.
Zebra,
according to the company. 855.
I wonder which one will be most valuable.
50 free. This is Free Talk Live.
When the most powerful and destructive witch in 13th century France chooses a successor, her frightened young protege, Liana, escapes into the wild. Pursued by witch hunters, the town watch, and her mistress, Liana's only hope is a pair of newly returned crusaders, one with PTSD, the other a complete rascal. The Witch's Hand by Wendy Joseph is a cut above the usual sword and sorcery fare, a thinking person's historical fantasy novel. Available now at your favorite booksellers or visit WendyJosephWrites.com. If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Wait a minute. Don't spend a dime on emergency food storage until you visit ReadySupplyFoods.com. If you're interested in getting the most high-quality food for your money, then see our comparison page where we list all the companies and rank them by value for your dollar.
you'll see that Ready Supply Foods sells 50% more food for your money than any other company. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. Make an informed decision by going to ReadySupplyFood.com today.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them, comment, it gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Talk Live, and you can join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. $1,600 is the asking price for the new micro pig that you can get from the Beijing Genomics Institute, BGI, based in China. You can also share your thoughts with us on that or whatever happens to be on your mind. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Apparently, some say there are some ethical questions about this, and you're welcome to share your thoughts. Also, you can join us online anytime at freetalklive.com. With you in the studio, you've got me, Ian.
Brian Henschy.
And Mark.
The micro pigs, according to sciencealert.com, were originally bred by applying gene editing techniques to the Bama pig. You ever heard of a Bama pig, Mark?
No, I haven't. But I can tell you that many pigs are around from around the world. Swine from around the world tends to be much smaller than what we expect here in sort of the United States and maybe England and the English-speaking world. The Yorkshire pig, from which you're likely it's the genetic forebearer of what you're eating mostly when you eat in the store, mm-hmm. is the English. These people loved to breed animals and breed them big. Yeah, breed them big, breed them selectively, and they did just a much better job than the vast majority of the world. There's certainly some people from argue that the Iberian pig's a better pig. Fine, that's whatever. But these they're just much bigger than most of the other pigs from around the world. So I wouldn't doubt that there's plenty of tiny little breeds out there.
The Bama pig was an already miniaturized breed that weighed between 30 and 50 kilograms. The new pig that they've now modified from the Bama pig doesn't get any higher than 15 kilograms. They've really cut it down in size.
50 kilos is about 100.
Just over 100 pounds.
Yeah, 100 pounds. That's a small pig. An adult.
And now it's even smaller with this.
Potentially you could pick that up if you had to.
You could get it
in the back of the Subaru.
I hope Vern Troyer gets a mini pig.
Who's that?
That's the guy from
Mini Me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Austin Powers.
BGI researchers cloned the Bama pigs using the used talon enzymes to block growth hormones in the cloned fetal cells. The stunted male pigs that resulted from the process were then bred with normal females, resulting in healthy second-generation micro pigs, which BGI says display no adverse health effects, or at least not yet. We don't know for how long these pigs have existed. You know, what is the oldest micro pig in existence at the moment? And, you know, of course, this will be one of the concerns, I think, of the people who are worried about this is, you know, like the like a lot of the dogs that are bred in captivity, the puppy mill puppies, as they're called, are these micro pigs going to be more likely to get sick? Are they going to be less resilient, as we've been talking about with college students? Are they going to be less resilient than their bigger pig counterparts?
I think it's a good question, but we need to consider that what people generally do with pigs is already, if you're the caller called in and asked about aggression, a pig's life is basically you know, about being eaten. Mm. If you're talking about a pig that is dealing with humans.
No.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know, 8 months, that's how long, 8 months is a long time. That's a market pig. But a lot of pigs you're eating, 5 months old.
Wow. So not everyone is thrilled with these pet developments. Numerous scientists are expressing ethical concerns over gene editing technologies being used for such what they consider frivolous ends. Geneticist Jens Bach told someone that it's questionable whether we should impact the life, health, and well-being of other animal species on this planet lightheartedly, he says.
And hey, of course, you know, the slaughterhouse is a few miles down the road from where he's talking about.
Of course, that's been going on for a long time, right? Like, as you pointed out, dogs have been bred for hundreds of years under the care of humans. And, you know, that's certainly something that you can argue that many of these dog breeds are weak and would never have existed. Like, you know, this lady I knew had a Chihuahua that she never took out of out of her purse, basically. So whenever she would actually take it out of the purse, it didn't really know how to walk. And it was so weak. Its muscles had basically atrophied in its legs.
And it's amazing too with breeding, like even like the American Bulldog. There was a thing on Nova on PBS, Dogs Decoded or something, and they talked about how the American Bulldog has been so bred now to have large shoulders and whatever.
Really.
And that it's not athletic anymore. They don't do well in hot conditions anymore.
They can't give birth. It has to be cesarean section.
For bulldogs?
For American bulldogs. Yes.
Get out of here.
No, I mean, it's insane.
So it's an inbreeding that is basically doing this? Well, what?
Well, no, it's breeding. Well, yeah, kind of inbreeding.
Breeding for the selective breeding.
Uh-huh.
But inbreeding in animals, you don't call it inbreeding, you call it line breeding.
It's the same thing.
No, line breeding is intentional.
You don't think inbreeding's intentional?
Words have meanings, my friend.
So anyway, back to the story here. Is it frivolous? Well, I mean, I would say some people are taking this very, very seriously. Obviously, the people at BGI are looking to, make some money off of this, and they're going to have to satisfy their customers. And, you know, from an animal rights perspective, if somebody's listening to this saying that this is wrong, you know, you're messing with the animals and God's plan or whatever.
Playing God.
But you're going to put more pigs in people's homes. You're going to increase the number of pigs that people are able to take care of and enjoy and, you know, experience and learn from. Pigs are arguably much smarter than dogs. There, some would say that.
Are they?
They're certainly very smart animals. There's no doubt about that.
I'm going to say pigs are as smart as dogs, but this is something that people need to not be misled on. Pigs are not dogs. Dogs are often smart in the ways that they wish to serve you and do things for you. Mm-hmm. Pigs have no interest in serving you.
Huh. They're more independent, right?
Right. The Churchill quote is really awesome. Dogs treat you as though you're their god. The cats treat you as though you're an inferior. Pigs treat you as though you're an equal. You know, pigs have really no interest in service to humans. They certainly may or may not like them. There's friendlier pigs and less friendlier pigs. But, you know, a smart pig is trying to get out of his pen.
Right. They'll cause trouble with their smarts.
Right. That's what they're...
I know nothing about pigs, so this is...
Yeah, they're up there with, like...
way too much about pigs.
Dolphins, pigs, chimpanzees, dogs, some of the smarter, you know, can be some of the smarter animals. Generally, dolphins and chimps are considered, I think, two of the smartest, and then pigs, I would say, are close behind.
Yeah, I'd say that.
And that's without them being...
But it's not a linear form of intelligence. Animals can have different sorts of intelligence.
Sure.
If you find a person who, say, has an IQ of 75 or 70, they still understand the future and understand, say, that they're going to die and things like that. Pigs don't have that knowledge. Even if you have a pig that has an IQ of 80 that's smarter than a person with an IQ of 75, you still don't have... they don't have the same breadth of knowledge.
Go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say, do pigs have, can they live in the wild?
And oh, yes.
I know that they're wild boars and
wild
such,
hogs.
And I've seen the Lion King and all that. And
a domestic pig will do just fine in the wild.
Really?
Yeah, in Texas.
Get out of here.
In Texas, there's no hunting season for pigs. You can kill them anytime you see them because so many have gotten
free. Let's go to Texas.
Free.
So even Lars Bolund, a geneticist who helped the company develop its gene editing platform for the micro pigs, was surprised by the company's announcement. They'll be selling the animals as pets. But according to one of their representatives, the micro pigs stole the show at the recent Shenzhen conference. We had a bigger crowd than anyone, said one of their reps. People were attached to them. Everyone wanted to hold them. So,
you can hold them.
They're tiny pigs.
Yeah, I get it. But if I've held tiny pigs and you'd think you were committing a murder if you hold a baby pig. It is a very rare pig that gets sort of comfortable. We had Lady Bird got used to it because she was being bottle fed and that sort of thing. So you can.
Well, that's just it. These pigs are raised around humans. They're not out in a pen the entire time. They're in a household or in a lab. They're always being interacted with.
They need
a human.
To be.
So I'm fascinated by it, and it'll be interesting to see, what happens with the initial orders and how the initial batch of them goes. How long do these things live? What's the lifespan of a micro pig? What's a typical if you were to let a pig live and not slaughter it? Do you happen to know, Mark?
I would guess that it was something like 10 years, but with dogs, bigger dogs like a Great Dane will last you 6 years, basically, whereas the littler dogs can go 20.
Just typing in pig lifespan into Google comes up with 8 years for the pig.
So will a smaller pig live longer or shorter?
Yeah.
You just don't know the answer.
Give us a call here on Pig Talk Live.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I bet there's a lot of people excited about this.
I think our longtime listeners just throw pig stories out to see how long I will talk about them.
Yeah, how many do you have right now, Mark? 20?
We're at 20.
Down from 40-ish? 50?
Yeah, we had 50 pigs at one point, but you're talking about little babies, so they were, on the. We had a piglet blowout sale on Labor Day, and just sold them all at $50. Don't expect to get a piglet.
That sounds like violence. Pig blowout.
All right, so if we hear more about the micro pig, we'll certainly let you know about it. And if you happen to get one, you'll have to tell us all about it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Get a harness. Pigs don't have necks.
855-450-3733. And you can, of course, bring up anything you want. Also, we can talk about, on the way here, the right to die. It is expanding down into a new state, which I think is good news. But you can tell us how you feel about it. Hour number 3 is on the way. Take control of the airwaves here on Free Talk Live, and you can join us on Skype as Skype username lrn.fm. Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof form of money to the people, where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom and the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, October 5th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.40 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,135 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $239. Antiwar.com reports, while the White House is making it clear they are opposed to Russian airstrikes against the Islamic State, those strikes are being met with growing statements of support from top U.S. allies in the war. On Friday, the Syrian Kurdish faction of the YPG endorsed Russia, unsurprising as they are often allies of the Assad government in fighting the Islamic State. On Saturday, the Iraqi Kurds echoed that support. A new statement from President Masoud Barzani of Iraq's Kurdistan Regional Government says that he welcomes the assistance of any country, including Russia, in the battle against the Islamic State, and hopes Russia will support the Peshmerga forces in their fights against the Islamic State. Barzani's statement also included a call for the U.S. to coordinate with Russia on their fight against the Islamic State, something U.S. officials have repeatedly ruled out, saying they believe the war against the Islamic State would be much more effective if everyone was working together. Russia offered coordination with the U.S. ahead of their strikes and urged the U.S. to join a new intelligence sharing endeavor in Baghdad, though the U.S. has refused. Barzani's endorsement may also reflect growing support for Russia across Iraq in general. The U.S. and the Abadi government haven't been on the best of terms recently, and their new coziness with Russia may be a decent bargaining chip when dealing with the U.S. Though the Kurdish Peshmerga has been arguably the closest U.S. ally throughout the war, the group has accepted aid from other groups, even those the U.S. is not on good terms with. Among the first nations to provide the Peshmerga with arms was Iran.
Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co.
UPI reports the U.S. Department of Defense said it is considering three Colorado prisons as potential sites to house terrorism suspects detained at the military prison in Guantanamo Bay, Cuba. The Pentagon plans to send a team to locations in Colorado, including the so-called Supermax or ADX Florence prison, home to some of the country's most notorious criminals, including Unabomber Ted Kaczynski and Oklahoma City bomber Terry Nichols. Military officials announced they plan a visit to the medium-sized federal prison near ADX Florence and a state-run maximum security prison about 10 miles away, the Colorado State Penitentiary. The trip is intended to determine if any of the facilities will be suitable to transfer some of the Guantanamo detainees, but it will also help officials understand the potential cost of moving the detainees to similar facilities across the United States. The idea has prompted immediate pushback from Colorado lawmakers who say federal statutes bar them from bringing detainees onto U.S. soil.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports search and rescue teams on Sunday located debris appearing to belong to the cargo ship El Faro, which went missing in the eye of the Hurricane Joaquin, with 33 mostly American crew members aboard more than 3 days ago, according to the U.S. Coast Guard and the ship's owner. Tim Nolan, president of the ship's owner, Tote Maritime Puerto Rico, said in a statement there was no sighting of El Faro or any of its lifeboats. With no word on the fate of the crew, relatives gathered at a Seafarers Union Hall in Jacksonville, Florida, where they were briefed by the Coast Guard and the ship's owner. Late Sunday, the Coast Guard tweeted that the debris field covered 225 miles and included styrofoam, wood, cargo, and other items. The Coast Guard could not confirm that the objects belonged to the ship, which sent a distress signal on Thursday morning in the Bahamas, but has not been heard from since. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
I recently signed up for one of these self-defense classes and brought along a camera crew to watch. Take a good look at this class instructor.
Thank you very much.
Boy, was he smooth. He tried to butter us up with flowery compliments like, good work, nice try. But don't worry, folks, I wasn't letting my guard down for one second. Maybe he wasn't planning to attack me at all, but he could potentially plan to attack me at some point, and that left only one option. Take him out first. This is him. This is the guy. My quarry approached, and when the moment was right, I struck. I knew he'd be able to counter my every move if I just did what he had taught me, so instead, I did exactly the opposite. I beat him with a baseball bat.
I am Shelby Cross! Do not ever attack me!
Now, folks, I acknowledge that this man may have never been a threat, but a potential threat is just as dangerous as a real one. I don't play games with my life, and neither should you, and that's it.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live. And you can join us here. Everything from micro pigs to college students who are not able to take care of themselves. In shocking ways, calling the college and their guidance department, basically the counseling services department, when they've been called a bitch by a roommate or when they saw a mouse in their off-campus apartment. These are just two examples of the overprotected mentality of a lot of people in this country and what it is leading to in the young people, which is the lack of responsibility, the lack of being able to take care of oneself. And joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Brian Henchy.
And Mark.
Our toll-free number for you is 855-450-FREE, and you're still welcome to call in on the college subject. I've actually got a few more words from freerangekids.com to sort of bring this back around. And then on the way, there's news about the right to die. It is expanding, and I'd like to know if anybody out there thinks it's a bad thing. Shouldn't people be able to kill themselves? And if you truly own yourself and that you are your own person, shouldn't you be able to end your own life legally? Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733, or Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. The author here over at Free Range Kids is Peter Gray. He is a psychology professor and the author of Free to Learn. And there was a meeting recently at the school at which he teaches in order to discuss the problem with college students, decline in resilience, a decline in their resilience, their personal resilience from being able to just handle life being thrown at them. Another point that they made here is that Gray's College is hardly the only institution that's worried about this. He quotes the author of a recent piece in the Chronicle of Higher Education, Robin Wilson, who wrote, quote, "Increasingly, students and their parents are asking the personnel at our institutions to be substitute parents. There is also the ever-present threat and reality of lawsuits. When a suicide occurs or a serious mental breakdown occurs, the institution is often held responsible."
And sure, I mean, you know, what the last staff member that interacted with this kid could be the one that, you know, they're giving them a bad grade or whatever might be what's the complaint is.
Did you hear about the campus shooting in Oregon or whatever, that they canceled classes until October, I think it was 12th or 14th?
I did not hear that.
They canceled class for like 2 weeks or a week and a half, whatever, because of the
supposed
shooting.
Grieving or whatever?
I guess so. I mean, but their class, they were only on like day three or four or something, or maybe day two of classes, and they canceled so many days of school. I mean, I think if this happened at one of my colleges way back when, probably classes maybe for 2 days, and then
or shut down the classrooms that it occurred in. But you know, things might go on normally with maybe some counseling if people needed it.
Now that I think about it, when I was in middle school, there was a kid who did commit suicide, and I think we
at school or off campus.
It was off campus.
Okay.
Yeah, off of school, and I think classes were canceled for I don't even think classes. No, they didn't cancel classes at all.
I remember there when kids died, when I was in school, they'd always have some sort of counselor available in case somebody wanted to go talk to them or whatever, but they never canceled the entirety of school.
Yeah, I think pretty much what ended up happening was that all the, like most of the kids did not go to school the next day, but they still had classes, and if they had enough kids to hold the class, then they had the class. But
well, I say the learning should go on.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, what passes for it.
Life goes on as insensitive as life is.
So Gray concludes, in previous posts, I have described the dramatic decline over the past few decades in children's opportunities to play, explore, and pursue their own interests away from adults. Among the consequences I've argued are well-documented increases in anxiety and depression and decreases in the sense of control of their own lives. We have raised a generation of young people who have not been given the opportunity to learn how to solve their own problems. They have not been given the opportunity to get into trouble and find their own way out, to experience failure and realize they can survive it, to be called bad names by others and learn how to respond without adult intervention. So now, here's what we have. Young people, 18 years and older, going to college, still unable or unwilling to take responsibility for themselves, still feeling that if a problem arises, they need an adult to solve it. But I don't blame parents, or certainly not just parents, says Gray. Parents are in some way victims of larger forces in society, victims of the continuous exhortations from the experts about the dangers of letting kids be, victims of the increased power of the school system and the schooling mentality that says kids develop best when carefully guided and supervised by adults.
It does seem like that. It seems like the parents are constantly getting told, intervene, intervene, intervene.
And victims of increased legal and social sanctions for allowing kids into public spaces without adult accompaniment. We have become, unfortunately, a helicopter society. If we want to prepare our kids for college or for anything else in life, we have to counter all of these social forces. We have to give our children the freedom, which children have always enjoyed in the past, to get away from adults so they can practice being adults, that is, practice taking responsibility for themselves.
Working on fairness, a variety of things that kids are going to have to figure to some extent for them or another for themselves.
Yeah, I thought it was a great piece. Again, freerangekids.com. You can go there. It's one of the blogs that that I subscribe to. There's always really interesting content there. So what are some ways that you can counter these social pressures? I mean, as a parent, the news isn't going to change for you. They're going to keep reporting the scary stories and the so-called experts, unless they happen to call in Lenora Skenazy or this Peter Gray guy. The experts on TV are going to be talking about the fear factor and, you know, keep your kids safe and all kinds of fear-mongering. So how do you counter that as a parent?
Well, I would say that the first things that you would consider is to let your kids try some things on their own. I don't mean force your kids necessarily to try things on their own. There are things they want to try on their own. I'm not suggesting chainsaw juggling. But I mean, there's, you know, other things that we can look at here that are something less dangerous than chainsaw juggling. And then
I would let my child juggle. No.
And then
how about a hedge trimmer?
Right. And then start looking at, encouraging them to do things on their own. Because if kids can't play together, one thing I find myself doing is when Jack's playing with other kids is I'll be, you know, half listening or whatever. I hear my son. I don't really care about those other kids, what they're doing. And when I hear my son sort of being unfair in the way that he's treating somebody else, I'll be like, hey, you know, maybe we could go about doing things this way. And today, I was, a friend was over, a friend's child was over. He and his wife, he wasn't there. His wife was hanging out with my wife. And I just noticed that the kids were playing together. I didn't particularly like the way that Jack was playing the game. And I was just trying to tell him to be more fair or whatever. And then after a while, the kids seemed to be taking advantage of Jack not being sort of as aggressive as he could be in the way they were playing. And then I'm like, I don't like the way the other kid's playing. Hmm. I should just butt out of this because I'm not helping at all. So I went downstairs and got out of there.
And it worked out.
Whatever. I mean, they both lived. They'll be fine.
So if
they don't hate each other.
If you want to share your thoughts here, you can join us and tell your story, especially if you've encountered these parents, these helicopter parents. If you've been at a school, for instance, at a college, and you've encountered these students that are acting like their children, you want to share your story, you're welcome to join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And I can understand that society can be overwhelming at times and, you know, it's frustrating seeing some of the ridiculousness, but is ending your own life the way? Is it the solution? Well, now you can apparently legally do so in California. And, Brian, I don't know if you have that story pulled up. If not, I can pull it up over here.
But yeah, I got it.
You had told me that there's news in California. And, of course, Washington State, I believe, was first to do the right to die with the Jack Kevorkian situation, if I'm recalling correctly. Didn't Oregon also legalize right to die? Does anyone know?
Yeah, Oregon's been right to die for a long time.
Well, wasn't it Washington State that did
it first?
I thought
it was Oregon.
Okay, I'll have to look. You might be right about that. I think you might be right. But now California's on board. Brian, you want to tell the story?
Sure. So this is from People.com that Brittany Maynard was trying to get. She had an issue. We're running out of time.
Well, we'll talk about it here. Our toll-free number, we're never out of time completely because we do a show 7 nights a week. But we've got time for you if you want to join us here. Plenty of that. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Also, you can chime in here on Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. Shouldn't people be able to decide to end their own lives? It's Free Talk Live.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
You haven't experienced yogurt until you've tried Amasi, embodying health and flavor in a true whole milk, green-fed dairy beverage. Every sip pays homage to our old-world cows and the ancient culturing methods their milk benefits from. With over 30 probiotics, Amasi's undeniably nutritious, refined, cultured sensation bolsters your health and awakens your passion for dairy. Amasi's so good, and you need to try it. Contact your Youngevity distributor or call 877-878-4203 or go to gcnteam.com.
Ted Anderson telling you about Jordan Rubin's Beyond Organic Green-Fed Raw Cheddar Artesian Cheese featuring whole milk created through ancient dairy breeding. Unpasteurized, untreated whole milk on the same farm the cows graze. Containing natural sources of omega-3s, CLA protein, calcium, probiotics, and enzymes. I have never tasted cheese this good, and you need to try it. Contact your Youngevity distributor or call 877-878-4203 or go to gcnteam.com.
Do you ever say, I could care less, when you really mean the opposite? You mean to say, I couldn't care less. It's a common mistake. You are judged by how you speak, especially if you're looking for work, with so many more applicants than openings now. But even if you're not, avoiding common misstatements will help you make the most of the dozens of conversations and transactions that crowd your daily routine. So whatever you say, don't say whatever as a single word sentence. It's the most annoying expression in the American English language, according to a recent poll. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. But seriously, at the end of the day, you'll want to avoid this scenario, sounding like everyone else. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
It is Free Talk Live, and you can join us toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can also join us online via Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. Feel free to contact us. That way you'll sound almost like you're sitting in the studio with us here. And online, we've talked about saveatpurse.com. It is a website that you can go to save big time on your Amazon purchases. And Mark, you just set a record for your household, isn't that right?
Yeah, my son had gotten he saved up all of his money for a very long time in order and sold his Thomas the Tank Engine set. He had this whole, you know, tracks and everything, and he just sort of outgrown it. And he wanted to get the Shield Helicarrier Lego set.
Okay.
And this thing's expensive. I'm like, you know,
what are we talking about? How much?
$350. Yeah, it's one of these big sets, and it's made for like a 14-year-old to put together.
Oh, wow.
I told him, I'm not going to touch it. I did actually help him with a little bit of gearing. It really has gearing. Like,
wow.
It, you know, like you spin this crank and it turns some engines or whatever. I helped him get that exactly right. But other than that, he put the whole giant thing together. But we had gotten it on purse, so there was a savings of like 20%, and 20% off $350s, you know, some money. And so he had some money left over from having saved this $350. So I suggested that we put a bid in on something while he waited to build up to this next thing he wanted. Just put in a bid on this next thing you want, and then we can sort of increase your bid as time goes by. So the first thing we put it in on was what he had left over, and he got somebody picked it up. We had no expectation it was going to happen. 45% off of the Marvel Quinjet from, you know, the movies. It was Lego.
Mm-hmm.
And he got it. It just showed up in the mail. We didn't even know that it had been picked up, and it showed up today, and I suspect it's together at this point.
Well, normally you'll know because Purse will send you emails that you said hadn't checked your email or something like that.
I don't check. It's not my job.
I see.
Yeah, this is something that Laura handles, and she doesn't check her email nearly as often as I check mine.
So you go to saveatpurse.com and 45%. Now, you're not going to get that filled usually immediately. It took you, what, a few days?
Yeah, a few days, but surprisingly quickly.
Yeah, I got 40% off of Blu-ray, and it took maybe 3 or 4 days there. So the higher the percentage discount you want, the longer it will take to fulfill, if it fulfills. Like, I tried 50% on something once, and it didn't happen, so I had to lower it. But the average buy through saveatpurse.com is 20% savings off of Amazon, and that alone is nothing to turn your nose up at. And, you know, if you put 20% out there, that thing is going to get filled within hours of when you place the order. So go and check it out. It's really easy to learn. It does require Bitcoin. That's the catch here.
Gotta get some Bitcoin.
That's how you get these deep discounts from Amazon, is you have to pay with Bitcoin, and you do it through saveatpurse.com. Go to saveatpurse.com. And start saving. Why not? There's no reason not to do this. It works very, very well.
Yeah, who doesn't want to save 45%?
Now, Brian Henchy is here with us. You brought a story in tonight from People Magazine about the right to die. It's expanding. We actually probably have about as many right to die states now as legal marijuana states, as a matter of fact. And the story is about a young lady who has gone ahead and taken her own life, Brittany Maynard.
Yep, in California. And she was beautiful, by the way.
Absolutely.
You see the picture, she was stunning. But anyway, she had been diagnosed with terminal brain cancer in 2014. And she was 29. She lived in Alamo, California with her husband. And they actually moved to Portland, Oregon in order to access their Death with Dignity Act so she could assisted suicide.
Yeah.
Right. So the so recently it was passed in California, and Governor Jerry Brown signed it into law. And so it was 1 year to the day that Brittany Maynard launched her online campaign to make Death with Dignity available nationwide. Governor Jerry Brown signed it into law in California. So, sorry, I love Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yeah. So, but anyway.
Nothing wrong with a good accent.
I like him better as an actor.
California, yeah. So I think my my thing with this, and I personally, like, so we were talking about calling up suicide hotlines earlier in the first hour of the show. And, you know, I tend to think of suicide as being a horrible, terrible thing for somebody to do. And that's under the assumption that it's being done irresponsibly.
You mean someone who's not terminally ill? Somebody just like, somebody, I hate my life.
Right. And they just blow their brains out or whatever. If you have, especially if you have kids, and, you know, you have responsibilities like that, it's very irresponsible to take your own life. However, in a circumstance with this, if you're diagnosed with a terminal illness, you're going to die. If you take care of your situation, meaning like, you know, have all the paperwork done, who's going to get your property after you die, say goodbye to people. You don't leave a huge mess behind. I think typically when people commit suicide, it messes up. Like the person who had the problem, they're gone.
Yeah.
But they've
created
now,
a big mess for
they've
everybody
They've now transferred their problems
to everyone
to
else.
Everybody that they knew and cared about them. So here it is that
they. Can you tell me some of these problems that you might be imagining that they would be transferring to other people? Because I can certainly see, you know, a big bloody mess in the living room.
That there's that.
There's a problem.
How about having to clean up a business or some other kind of loose end that they left out there, an unpaid mortgage
but like
or whatever?
Those, yep. But like those people who are left behind who cared
kids,
about this person.
Kids
who,
they were taking care
who
of?
Who are left there saying, God, I wish I knew because I cared about this person and I wanted them to live on. And
yeah, usually it's
oh
very abrupt. They didn't see it coming. The
right,
didn't
right.
See it
well,
coming.
If you did, if you tell them you're going to commit suicide, then they're going to have you institutionalized. This is one of the difficulties with the scenario.
I mean, like Robin Williams, when he committed suicide yeah. a while back.
The world
back.
Grieved. There's no doubt about
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah. And to think, you know, here it is that somebody has this big problem that they're dealing with, and he had dealt with depression and whatever, all sorts of issues for a long time. And, you know, as long as he took care of his affairs, made sure that his kids were all set, did all the paperwork, and, you know, at least gave people a chance to say goodbye. I mean, at the end of the day, you own your own life. Mm-hmm. But if you leave a big mess behind, and
that's
you
why people call it selfish.
Tie up yeah. all the loose ends and whatever, then that's incredibly irresponsible and selfish. It's incredibly selfish when people commit suicide most of the time. But in a situation like this, you have terminal brain cancer and you're going to die. I mean, the
painfully likely. Yeah.
Yeah. It's going to be a horrible death. I had my aunt in my family. She had COPD. She had a bunch of issues. She basically went to a hospital in March of last year and did not go home ever again.
How long
they were going to treat her
in the hospital?
They thought they were going to treat her for like a few days or a week, mm-hmm. and she ended up going between all these rehab centers, whatever. But the long story short is that, like knowing what we knew in hindsight, whatever, it probably would have been better if she was able to avoid like the 6 or 9 months of suffering.
And what's that,
she
cost,
had.
By the way? I mean, it, you know,
right,
nine
right.
months under permanent care, you know, you're in a facility every single day, 24 hours a day. Somebody's going to pay that bill, and it's likely going to be her, which means she'll have less. She'll have
case.
Or taxpayers.
Yeah.
But let's presume she had the money. You know, if she's expending her life savings just trying to keep herself alive for 6 to 9 months in this sort of dire state, you know, then she dies anyway. That leaves less for her grandchildren and her children as far as the will is concerned.
Life is a terminal illness.
You can join us here. Actually, there's a quote in this story from Tim Rosales, a spokesman for Californians Against Assisted Suicide. So I really want to know what the opposition had to say about this. What is it that, you know, why would you oppose somebody's right to take their own life? The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Wait a minute. Don't spend a dime on emergency food storage until you visit ReadySupplyFoods.com. If you're interested in getting the most high-quality food for your money, then see our comparison page where we list all the companies and rank them by value for your dollar. You'll see that Ready Supply Foods sells 50% more food for your money than any other company. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. Make an informed decision by going to ReadySupplyFood.com today.
This is Sharon Hunt. Before using Heart and Body Extract, my energy level was very, very low. I could only walk a few feet and then would have to sit down. I was tired and lethargic. But after taking Heart and Body Extract, my energy level has improved greatly and I can now walk longer distances without getting tired so fast. Thank you, Heart and Body Extract.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at HBExtract.com.
Free Talk Live.
Pushing women to the ground with a camera in her hand, you know, yeah. I think a real man wouldn't do that. And you got to be on roids or something to get into that state of mind.
Well, Wayne hit it on the head. If they're not on steroids, and a number of them, some of them are, most of them probably aren't. They're not on steroids, maybe, but they're definitely high on adrenaline. Former drug task force officer, when he started with the police, you know, he would get that adrenaline rush from writing a ticket. And then, of course, he acclimated himself to it, and then he needed something else. He needed to escalate. He needed to have something else. So it got so extreme that he would leave people uncuffed. Like he'd bust a coke dealer or something like that, mm-hmm. and then just leave them uncuffed on the hopes that they would get up and try to run.
So he kicks some butt.
Right. Exactly. Yeah.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order, you're going to obey it.
Which order you can go this way?
You can do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Hey,
who do you think
you
are?
Excuse
me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait,
you gotta
come.
Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this? Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us online. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Online option for you is Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. And again, that toll-free number, 855-450-3733. If you are against assisted suicide,
I want to hear why. Now, I do have the list of supposed facts from the Californians against assisted suicide. We can go through what they have to say about it, but I also would love to hear from you. And with you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
Brian Henchy.
And Mark.
And don't forget, you can, if you need to, let's say you need to get a will, you can go to LegalZoom.com.
You need the paperwork done.
Yeah, you know, somebody's got to do that for you. Why not do it yourself through LegalZoom.com and save big time compared to actually hiring an attorney? You can actually save even more by using code FTL, like Free Talk Live, over at LegalZoom.com. And it's not just wills, it's patents, it's trademarks, it's incorporation. LegalZoom.com, code FTL, saves $10 off your order. So, Brian, you just told us about the story from People.com, the good news that California, now the fifth state to legalize your ability to take your own life through an assisted suicide kind of situation, terminal illness, etc. Now, there's opposition to this, and they are embodied by the Californians Against Assisted Suicide. Tim Rosales, their spokesman, actively opposed the bill, saying that they are considering their options. He says, "This is a dark day for California and for the Brown administration. Governor Brown was clear in his statement that this was based on his personal background. The governor's background is very different than that of millions of Californians living in healthcare poverty without that same access. These are the people and families potentially hurt by giving doctors the power to prescribe lethal overdoses to patients."
I mean, it is a bit of a slippery slope, though, right?
Is it?
I mean, what if you have somebody who's not totally mentally capable of understanding what it is that they'd actually potentially be doing, or you just have somebody who's feeling very depressed, and it's not that they it's not like they're gonna die that soon, that they could have a quality of life for quite a while, but they're just feeling very depressed.
Are you suggesting that there would be an unscrupulous doctor who would just all willy-nilly suggest suicide that as a solution?
Are there unscrupulous doctors?
There are, but if the doctor was truly unscrupulous, wouldn't he want to keep the patient alive to keep milking them for money?
What if a eugenics organization comes into play and says, you know what we need? Not eugenics, may not be the right term. Just some of these people that believe there's overpopulation on the planet. Mm-hmm. What if one of these organizations just decides to fund a doctor who goes around finding people who are having a bad day, right? Like these. I'm just saying, if you want your what ifs, I can come up with your what ifs.
It's none of my damn business.
The next step down the road in sort of legalizing suicide is encouraging suicide. You know what? You're a real drain on your
cases,
family.
It should be encouraged. That's limited saying. Circumstances. Very limited.
Well, that's, of course, what the Californians Against Assisted Suicide have to say here in part. These are their alleged facts from their website, noassistedsuicideca.org. Assisted suicide legalization has failed more times than it has succeeded, they say. There have been well over 100 legalization attempts in the past 20 years, yet only 3 states have actually legalized it through legislative or voter action.
I don't think that our political campaign to get suicide legalized is a particularly good argument. Your campaign could fail. Is likely to fail is a good argument for not having the campaign.
Well, I think they're arguing that the social idea that it hasn't been working other places, so you guys
should
try it as well.
It's argumentum ad populum. This is nobody really wants this, so here's the proof that nobody really wants it. The state legislatures can't work it out.
The abolitionists had a terrible time getting slavery, gotten rid of.
Thank God for Republicans.
Right, there you go.
Because Republicans got that through.
Indeed.
If assisted suicide is made legal, they say here, it quickly becomes just another form of treatment, and as such will always be the cheapest option. This is troublesome in a cost-conscious healthcare environment.
That's the death panels, right? Everybody's worried about these death panels. So is it cheaper to kill somebody than to treat them? Yeah. Maybe the doctor says, hey, you know what I think the best treatment for this is just get your stuff in
lead.
Order.
Well, and this... The facts here, their supposed facts, presumes, and I guess rightfully so, that it doesn't seem like they're really trying to persuade anyone with this. This presumes that the person reading this is kind of already on their side. Look, here's some facts. You can throw these facts out at your friends and, try to, make an argument or whatever. But they're not really, I don't think this is very persuasive because, to me, if you own your own body and there is an issue with your health, now how quickly you're going to die from whatever that issue is, I don't think is relevant. Cost is a realistic consideration. And even with a so-called universal healthcare system, which we certainly don't advocate on Free Talk Live because it's government control of your healthcare, which is a very important thing. And you don't want to put the government in charge of things that are important in life.
Like national security
or any of that stuff.
It's a pretty good argument. They haven't been doing a very good job with it.
Yeah, no kidding.
You should be able to make these decisions for yourself. And when it comes to your finances, it's not just about you. It's about your family. And it's devastating to a family to have a family member come down with some sort of terminal problem or even a serious illness. And if that family member decides, hey, look, I've had a good life here. I had two kids. I had a successful business. And this is not a bright future for me. Whatever, fill in the disease. This is not going to be a good future for me. I'd rather go ahead and end this now rather than force my kids and wife or whoever to take care of me, to wipe my butt when I go to the bathroom and, have to give me
a sponge bath.
Give me a sponge bath and, go through all this hassle.
I'd like a sponge bath.
Where you could be making the world a better place. You could be out there doing the things that you wanted to do instead of taking care of somebody who doesn't even want to be on this earth to be taken care of. Shouldn't they be able to make that decision?
So very, very quick story. George Eastman, the founder of Kodak.
Is it about sponge baths?
I worked briefly as a co-op for Eastman Kodak.
What's a co-op?
Co-op. It's when you go to college and you spend time in class, and then part of the year you work full time in your major.
Oh, so you're actually getting paid.
Corporation.
Okay.
Depending on your major. Yes.
Okay. Got it.
So I was working at this Kodak plant and making photographic gelatin. And anyway, that's aside from the story here. But George Eastman, the founder of Kodak, he was very smart. He was an engineer. He had a lot of control over how Kodak was developing its products and whatever, CEO. He found out that he had dementia. He was starting to lose his mind.
Yeah.
It may have been Alzheimer's, but I don't remember specifically.
They're both bad.
But long story short, he got his family together. He got all his paperwork together, had everything out, invited everybody over, whatever, after he said hello and whatever to everybody. He asked them to leave the room, and then they heard a gunshot, and he took his own life. Now, this guy was a guy who had hundreds and hundreds of trees in his orchards that he had on his property up in upstate New York. And he was starting to lose his mind.
Yeah.
And he did not want to be out of control of not, being able to do the day-to-day stuff and be able to lose your mind.
You become a burden on your family.
When you want to live your life a certain way and you cannot live that way... I mean,
why would you want to stay around?
Why would I want Ian Freeman to say, no, Brian Henschke, you have to stay alive.
And be crazy for the next 20 years
You've
or
lost
10
your
years
mind, but I want you to be a cattle in a pen somewhere.
That's it. You sit in this assisted living facility and, they spoon feed you when it comes down to the very end.
And waste away.
I just went today to see a friend in the nursing home. I go to see him generally weekly, and he... this guy's brilliant. He's a brilliant composer, really smart guy. Love to talk to him. But he's having some memory issues.
Mm-hmm.
And I can see that it frustrates him greatly. Now, I'm not suggesting how his life go from here on out, but I do know that he spends time with a lot of people who are not nearly as well off mentally as he is.
Mm-hmm.
And I can only imagine what it might be like.
It can't be good for you.
To be in a circumstance where you feel, your memory's going. I know what it's like. My memory's going now. But what it's like for him, he's 85 or however old he is, and, is slipping a little bit, and he sees these people around him that are same age, sometimes younger, sometimes mm-hmm. older, that are in much worse shape. What must that be like? What are the pressures like?
If you want to share your experience, your thoughts, get some more points here, the facts, alleged facts from the Californians Against Assisted Suicide, maybe they can talk me out of this, but I think that you should be able to do this if you want, and you should be able to decide at any point to end your life. 855-450-FREE. I do like Brian's suggestion that you should do it responsibly.
Responsibly.
But, if you can't do it legally, then you end up with a gunshot like the Eastman story you were telling us about. It's Free Talk Live.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof money to the people where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom in the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At ContractorExam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, ContractorExam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.ContractorExam.com today.
Are you getting squeezed by the economic downturn? Hey, you were doing fine. Then, all of a sudden, you're having a tough time paying your family's credit card bills. Maybe you were downsized or even lost a job, but you still owe 10 grand or more in credit card bills. And you just can't afford the minimum payments anymore. We're here to help. We are the Genesis Debt Partners. We know the secrets to negotiate better terms with your creditors. Make a free 10-minute call right now and learn how we can help you get out of debt. 800-981-7590. If you owe 10 grand or more in credit card debt and you want to learn how you can pay less and get out of debt faster, call right now. 800-981-7590. 800-981-7590. Get out of debt now. 800-981-7590.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Monday, gold is $3 higher at $1,142 per ounce. Silver is up 42 cents at $15.73 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $238. Looking for silver? We have plenty of Australian silver spiders and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here in these remaining moments. We have enough time for you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Also, we've got Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. Going through the list of supposed facts, according to the Californians Against Assisted Suicide, because it's hard to dig somebody up who's willing to actually come on the radio and say, you know, within our audience, like, oh, who agrees or who opposes the idea that you should be able to end your own life? I mean, I think it's ridiculous that somebody would say you shouldn't be able to take your own life legally. But yet 45 states, it's still completely illegal to do that. Now California has become the fifth state to legalize assisted suicide. I think it's a good news. I think it's great news.
How do you enforce that law, by the way? How do you enforce no suicide?
If you If you fail at suicide, you get arrested.
Yeah.
It's attempted suicide's a crime.
You. I don't think that there's two. Where is this? Do you have an instance? Because I think it's mostly this is for doctors. That this is a crime that is enforced against doctors. The doctors
sure,
can't
assisting
help
with someone with suicide. Yeah.
If
that would
you
be a doctor.
Want to die, probably. I mean, you can pull that off. It's just that most people want it done by somebody else. So it's just a little easier for them. You know, make this easier. Put me out and then kill me or whatever. And that's a lot better than, writing everything down and then pulling the trigger on the shotgun. You know what I mean?
So here's the story, facts.
Such a depressing topic.
the alleged facts from the Californians against assisted suicide. They're going to try to persuade you here. To join their side, they say that assisted suicide poses a threat to those living with disabilities or who are in vulnerable circumstances. When assisted suicide becomes an option, explicit and implicit pressure is placed on these individuals to take that option.
Yeah, this is a claim of a friend who...
Suicide pushers, so to speak.
Yeah, this is a claim of a friend who's disabled. He has said over and over again he's not for the right to commit suicide, basically because he's of the opinion that people would be trying to kill him off. So, there you go.
But they'd have to get him to agree to it. You know, they wouldn't just murder the guy. They would have to persuade him to agree. Yes, I agree that suicide's my best option.
That's gonna be a great circle of friends. Hey, dude, you should totally kill yourself.
It's rough.
Sounds like 4chan. The safeguards
new friends.
They claim in Oregon and Washington have proven to be hollow, as they are easily circumvented. Patients are not required to receive a lethal prescription from their attending physician and can doctor shop. Meaning that there's options out there in the marketplace. And why shouldn't there be? Why shouldn't somebody be able to find a doctor who's willing to do this? Because not every doctor would be willing to provide the suicide, right? Like, that's right. Not their obligation. They can turn you down as a patient if they're morally
objecting. You hope so, but, at one point on Free Talk Live, we advocated for gay marriages, marriage licenses for gay people. I'm sure that wasn't going through my head was that they're going to force Christians to make wedding cakes for them.
Yeah, no, I see
so,
what you're saying.
Once you legalize suicides, then does every doctor that doesn't believe in suicide now have to provide it? This is one of the problems with advocating for liberty for people is that once they get liberty, then they're ready to, they got the whip of tyranny in the other hand for the other guy.
Well, it's a problem with, that's not the problem with liberty, it's a problem with a government existing and the state as we know it that is out there giving
the
people the opportunity.
Just people, and people want to terrorize those that they disagree with.
Well, it is a problem with people wanting to control the lives of others, and as long as that's what they want, they can't have liberty. If you want to control the lives of some other people, then you yourself can't be free.
Sadly, we are a ways from that.
It's not a problem with liberty at all. This is a problem with the litigious society that we have. People should be able to get married without the state's involvement at all. There's no reason for the state to be involved in marriage, but it is, and so you get consequences from that.
I would argue that the state does have an interest because every state wants to continue, and if you don't have more people, you know, families theoretically create children.
You're saying the state's interest is to keep suicide illegal?
No. The state's interest is to keep the society present so it doesn't just die out. So to have more children to keep that society going,
certainly.
The state would have an interest to keep the number of people increasing.
Yeah, that's true. More tax cattle for them to extract
that too.
Wealth from.
Yeah.
6-month diagnoses are arbitrary standards, says the Californians Against Assisted Suicide. Nothing prevents these laws from being expanded to include individuals with longer prognoses or people suffering, they put that in quotes, from other illnesses or disability. The longest and most studied examples of assisted suicide laws in Europe provide evidence for the expansion argument. So the idea being that I guess the proposal, I'm presuming, inferring from this this list here, the proposed law that is now the law in California requires a 6-month diagnosis, meaning the doctor would have to proclaim that you will die within 6 months in order for you to be able to access the assisted suicide.
There's a lot of terminal illnesses where somebody might suffer for longer than 6 months.
Yeah.
Just a thought.
Well, that's what they're saying here, Mark, is they'll start at 6 months and then it'll just expand from there and give people 5 years and they'll be able to kill themselves.
What about power of attorney? I have signed over power of attorney at a point in my life to allow my mother to make signatures for me and that sort of thing. Many times you'll have unhealthy people, turn over power of attorney to a loved one, will that loved one be able to make the decision as far as when your suicide occurs?
That's a good question. I think they should be able to do that if you want to grant them that ability.
I can tell you there's a, I had an aunt who had Alzheimer's, like the kind where you're there wandering the street sort of Alzheimer's.
My grandfather had that.
She hung around for a couple of decades like this. And there
were
people.
What's the hospital bill there?
Well, she was staying at home.
The nursing home bill.
There were people. I have no idea. They were rather wealthy. They had in-home nurses and that sort of thing. Her husband, who was older, was lucid, but having to deal with this situation. Yep. I can tell you there's people in the family, perhaps not as emotionally attached as her husband was. There was like, you know what would be better is if this lady was gone.
Hmm. And they say here in their next alleged fact here, the Californians Against Assisted Suicide, quote, nothing in the Oregon or Washington laws can protect from explicit or implicit family pressures to commit suicide or personal fears of being a burden. And I wouldn't want to be a burden on anybody. I wouldn't want to, you know, put my friends or family in a situation where, you know, I was all they had to deal with all day long. You know, if they couldn't afford to hire somebody
I'm just
to...
sitting over here thinking, you are all I have to deal with all day long.
You sit here for 3 hours a night.
Are you advocating for Ian to commit suicide?
I wouldn't want him to go on like this, Brian. I just don't want him to go on like this.
I don't think that there's, I don't think there's a problem with someone feeling like they're a burden on their loved ones. Because you are probably a burden on your loved ones. So end it.
It's ugly, but I do want to say very quickly, Jack Kevorkian, of course, he's probably the most well-known assisted suicide advocate. That's a guy that at that time, this is before I got into libertarian thinking and whatever, he's a guy that I very much disagreed with. But in hindsight, you have to give him so much credit for absolutely standing up for what he believed in.
He went to prison, right?
He went to jail to be willing to sacrifice his own freedom for what he really believed was a right that people should be able to have, and that individuals should be able to make that decision for themselves. So
yeah, that's heroic.
Certainly.
There's a couple more points here. Oregon's data on assisted suicide is flawed, they claim, incomplete and disorganized. The state does not investigate cases of abuse and has admitted that they cannot determine whether a physician-assisted suicide is being practiced outside of the framework of the Death with Dignity Act. And why should they be able to know? It's none of their damn business between you and your doctor. It's none of the state's business. What is happening in your hospital room or in the doctor's office? Is it?
Well, now with Obamacare, now it certainly is.
And it's, well, that's a good point,
we
right?
We prescribe suicide. Suicide for you. It's
well, yeah, that's where things get kind of scary, right? Like, if it's out of your hands, then that I would have a problem with, right? If, like, suicide is imposed upon you, that's not really suicide anymore, right? That's murder. But they also point out here, they claim that under the Oregon or Washington laws, there are no requirements that family be notified when an assisted suicide prescription request is made. And why should they be? It's none of their damn business either, unless you want them to know about
it. Well, what about the father of a, if a woman's pregnant and the father of the child has no idea that the woman wants to go get an abortion? What about something like that?
Yeah, that's a nice thing to let the dad know, but I'm of the opinion that it's completely within the woman's control to make those.
The reality is that it is. Yeah. I think that there's a good argument that that child was created together, and you know, shouldn't you have some information on that?
It's a nice thing to do, but again, it's your own personal medical business. It's your body. It shouldn't be anyone else's business unless you want to share it with them. And I think that's definitely the truth when it comes to the suicide law. Because, you know, you start mandating that all family members be given information about the fact that you want to kill yourself, and then all of a sudden they make a huge deal out of this.
If I give power of attorney to somebody else and they agree, you know, tell the doctor that they want to have me killed, do they have to notify me?
You figure that out. We're out of time for tonight, but we'll be back tomorrow night. Brian, do you have a website or anything like that you can
plug? Just follow me on Twitter, at Brian Henchy, H-E-N-C-H-E-Y. Thanks for having me on.
Perfect. Thanks for being here. It was great. Free Talk Live. See you tomorrow night. Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, Illegal Uber driver Christopher David. Neocash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp. State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A-plus by the NHLA. The Seditious Sirens. The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias. Tech guru Brian Sovereign. Cop blocker J.P. Freeman. New mover Dr. Taryn Lupo. Longtime political activist Dennis Goddard. Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul. Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. Rootwork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. Their nerds know business and can meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL to get your free call. That's rootwork.it/FTL.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, October 5th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.40 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,135 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $239. Antiwar.com reports, while the White House is making it clear they are opposed to Russian airstrikes against the Islamic State, those strikes are being met with growing statements of support from top U.S. allies in the war. On Friday, the Syrian Kurdish faction of the YPG endorsed Russia, unsurprising as they are often allies of the Assad government in fighting the Islamic State. On Saturday, the Iraqi Kurds echoed that support. A new statement from President Massoud Barzani of Iraq's Kurdistan Regional Government says that he welcomes the assistance of any country, including Russia, in the battle against the Islamic State, and hopes Russia will support the Peshmerga forces in their fights against the Islamic State. Barzani's statement also included a call for the U.S. to coordinate with Russia on their fight against the Islamic State, something U.S. officials have repeatedly ruled out, saying they believe the war against the Islamic State would be much more effective if everyone was working together. Russia offered coordination with the U.S. ahead of their strikes and urged the U.S. to join a new intelligence sharing endeavor in Baghdad, though the U.S. has refused. Barzani's endorsement may also reflect growing support for Russia across Iraq in general. The U.S. and the Abadi government haven't been on the best of terms recently, and their new coziness with Russia may be a decent bargaining chip when dealing with the U.S. Though the Kurdish Peshmerga has been arguably the closest U.S. ally throughout the war,